If you wreck your car, you need to come and see us. Now, we hope you don't wreck your car, but if you do, come and see us. Our collision repair center is unique. There isn't one like it in the Intermountain West.
Used People, Sunday at 2 on 4 Utah.
Spanning the globe to bring you the constant variety of sport.
The man is incredible.
The thrill of victory.
Absolutely the best.
And the agony of defeat.
And look at him go!
Oh, baby.
Oh, no.
This is ABC's Wide World of Sports.
After a season of turmoil and tragedy, a coach returns, determined to lead his team to another Final Four. Across the hardwood, a coach strives to bring a team respect in a state where football is king. Tradition and expectation collide as Rick Majerus and the Utes take on Rick Barnes and the Texas Longhorns. Texas and Utah coming up. Chris Owens, a guy who just about averages a double-double, 17 points, 8 rebounds a game. Welcome, John Saunders alongside Digger Phelps. And as we look at these two teams, they're on a roll. 2-3, that's how Texas started. They won 5 straight. Utah started 3-3. They've won 4 straight.
Yeah, Utah got embarrassed at Alabama where they lost by 15. Stanford got bumped off by Texas in Chicago. I was impressed with that win. T.J. Ford of Texas averaging close to 10 assists a game. That's the reason why Rick Barnes' team wants to get this big win for the Big 12. I think one of the deep teams in that conference, Texas.
And both teams at 7-3 right now, looking for their 8th victory of the season for Rick Majerus, turning things around after missing the last season. It is coming up next, the Utes and the Longhorns.
So what do you play?
Tenor sax.
I play a bad guitar myself.
Yeah?
I mean bad in the bad sense.
As long as you enjoy it.
You make a good living?
Well,
I do what I love in the 43 countries.
43?
Yeah.
You want to take next year off?
Well, no. I know you, Bob. I know you're serious.
Check this out. I'm going to lunch.
Well, it's not like we didn't anticipate this. Listen, let me talk to your accountant about the tax implications. We'll go from there.
That stock sector could have gone up or down hard. It was just too risky for you.
Thanks for the heads up on that one.
Sure. So how's your dad doing?
Well, that's what I really wanted to talk to you about.
People across the nation are getting the message. For great year-end values, amazing selection. Toyota-thon 02. Right now, you'll find everything you've been looking for in the all-new, redesigned Camry. Sleeker, more powerful, better than ever before. Which says a lot, given that Camry's been the best-selling car in America the last 4 years. Toyota-thon 02. Password, value.
Come in, you're expected.
Who says houses don't have feelings? Stephen King's Rose Red. Coming to ABC Sunday, January 27th at 9, 8 Central. Viewer discretion advised.
The Big 12 gets together with the Mountain West here in Salt Lake City today. A floor that has hosted NCAA regionals in the past and a pretty good December matchup today. Bob Carpenter, Jimmy Dykes. Let's talk about Chris Owens. Jimmy, Digger and John already talked about what a good player he is. What makes him the go-to guy he is for Rick Barnes?
You know what? He's always defended and rebounded like an All-American. Now he's scoring like an All-American, primarily because he has an outstanding point guard for the first time to get him the basketball in T.J. Ford. T.J. Ford leads the country in assists right now. The first thing I pack if I'm playing for Texas on a road trip is that guy right there, T.J. Ford. That's how important he is to Rick Barnes' squad.
Yeah, he's like your credit card. Don't leave home without him. The two guys, the inside-outside guys, Owens and Ford for Texas. And, of course, here in Salt Lake City, they know all about the Salt Lake skyline. They are tall with Chris Burgess, the Johnson boys, and then the guards. And there's Rick Barnes, fourth year at UT, 75 wins already, and his 15th year after some great seasons at George Mason, Providence, and Clemson. Rick Majerus back in the saddle out west here. Good to see him back healthy, back on the bench. And Rick, almost unbeatable on this floor, an amazing 92% percentage. Last year they got together, and Darren Kelly had a huge game for Texas. Each team has won three and lost one on their home floor in this eight-game series that's even at 4-4. Johnson and Owens tipping it up, and it was Britton Johnson getting the tap. Travis Spivey will start the Utah half-court offense.
Bob, Texas is one of the better half-court defensive teams in the nation. They've always played outstanding defense under Rick Barnes. A little bit quicker pace on the offensive end this year for the Longhorns.
Nick Jacobson on the perimeter. This is Jeff Johnson, older of the two brothers. Spivey against Ford, pair of number 11s, a couple of quick point guards today. Britton Johnson looks for his brother, flashing. Shot clock inside 10.
Texas will really get up on him this afternoon, trying to force Utah to do something off of the dribble drive. That is not their strength.
In the paint, a Texas foul on Jason Klotz, a 6'9 redshirt freshman out of Houston's Klein Forest High School. He's been starting the last three games. Jimmy and I saw him get some significant playing time at the Great Alaska Shootout a little over a month ago. This is Jeff Johnson on the drive. They got a fresh 35 on the shot clock.
Bob, Utah, if they're allowed to run their stuff, they almost do it to perfection. Very good utilizing that shot clock each possession.
Chris Owens blocking the shot by Spivey. It'll stay with the Utes on the baseline. There's Chris Owens, 17 points, 8 rebounds a game, leads them with 21 blocks now. Counting that one, the 159th block of his Texas career. Jacobson open, inside the arc, a little off to the left with it. Jeff Johnson went crashing, and a Jason Klotz rebound for the Longhorns.
We see Utah early in this ballgame. They're sending two guys to the offensive glass, three guys to the defensive end. That's the respect they have for this Texas running game right now.
Mouton for Ivy, Royale Ivy, the most intense Texas player, outstanding at the defensive end. Right wing for T.J. Ford, the freshman point guard. Shot clock approaching 10. They're picking a roll by Klotz. He was open, gets the pass, looking to face. T.J. Ford, a rare three. He's only shot 10 of them this year, making one. Owens the rebound, bounces off a Ute. Britton Johnson goes to the floor, and Chris Owens to the basket.
Owens does so many things, Bob, that will hurt you during a basketball game. And when he gets off on the offensive glass early, that's usually a sign he's going to have a big game.
Here's the ex-Duke player, Chris Burgess, high post. Jeff Johnson, good shot fake. Goes for the layup. Oh, it's Burgess on the flush.
If anyone has welcomed back Rick Majerus more than Chris Burgess, I don't know who it is. He has really taken his game to another level. He has adjusted to that constant proverbial barking every afternoon that comes out of the big guy in the sweater.
Maybe finally in his senior year, his fifth year as a collegiate player, he will fulfill his destiny or his potential. How about Britton Johnson on the floor with that steal? Here comes Travis Spivey for Utah. Straight ahead, deep for Burgess. He loves to turn to the baseline. Does, nothing under there. Then he takes the hook after traveling. Good defense, one-on-one by Chris Owens.
Talked about the big guys early in this ballgame. Look at Chris Owens again. Runs down the three-point shot by Ford and then just powers it right back at the rim. He's a power guy first, a finesse guy secondly, and then watch Burgess. He reads it great, runs straight down the middle of the lane, boom, and finishes. That's where you get a lot of your offensive boards, right in front of that rim where Burgess ended up.
2-2 game, 2.5 minutes in. Couple of teams, both 7-3. Texas surprisingly has a lot of Big 12 teams with better records than they do right now. Jimmy will talk more about that later. But the Longhorns have played a very demanding schedule so far.
Well, their November schedule was really tough.
Owens hanging, unable to score. Britton Johnson the rebound. Spivey will run. Utes come down 3-on-3. Against Ford and over him, too strong with the lay-in and the rebound. Royale Ivy, one of the best defensive players in the country.
Spivey got himself a little deep that time on the penetration, dribbled himself out of a shot.
T.J. Ford, the dish for Mouton. How about that for some room service? T.J. Ford, assist number 93 in their 11th game of the year. And he's turned it over 41 times. So a pretty good assist to turnover ratio, better than 2-1.
His vision for a freshman point guard as good as anybody in the country.
Jeff Johnson thought his three might get blocked. TJ Ford, alley-oop, backdoor, Mouton can't grab it.
Look at TJ Ford, talked about his vision. He always knows where all other nine guys are on the floor. Not just where his teammates are, but also where the defense is. And you see those Texas bigs really starting to adjust to his ability to penetrate and get the ball to him. That's a lot every afternoon, Bob, to get your hands in catching position at all times when Ford has that basketball.
Number 10 in orange, midcourt, Freddie Williams finally back in for Texas. Got hurt right at the end of their exhibition season. A bad knee, his first action since. He goes down, and how about that? Freddie Williams steps right in off the disabled list, if you will, and takes a charge.
Important guy because TJ Ford's been logging about 35, 36 minutes a game. This is a kid that can come in and spell Ford for 3 or 4, maybe 5 minutes a half. You don't want TJ Ford to get worn down this early in the season, and Rick Barnes was all smiles yesterday at practice when he realized that Freddie Williams was back in the lineup for him.
Not to mention the daily benefit of having him in practice to work against his freshman guard. There's Mouton, a handoff from James Thomas, who just checked in. Thomas to the rack. He takes a grab on the way. It appears to be on Eric Osmundson, who just checked in, a freshman guard.
Bob, with those Texas bigs, and you're looking at James Thomas right now, who's built like a yield sign, whose shoulders are wide and comes down to that little narrow waist, and guys like Owens and Boddicker and Klotz, they're a physical inside group. Anxious to see how Utah responds to that today.
69% free throw shooter is James Thomas. He got a technical foul in the second half of that game at Las Vegas last Saturday that let the Running Rebels get back in. Texas had led big by 16. Vegas got back to within one, and Texas eventually won it by 9. Here they are a week later, back out west and on top by 4 early.
People across the nation are getting the message. For great year-end values, amazing selection. Toyotathon 02. Now get 0% APR financing on some of Toyota's most popular models, like Corolla, the rugged V8 Tundra, the versatile 4Runner, and the roomy Sienna. Hurry, don't miss this incredible opportunity. Toyotathon 02, password value.
Hello?
NCAA basketball presented by UBS Payne Weber on ABC Sports, brought to you by UBS Payne Weber, because life is a continuing story. Toyota, get the feeling. And Singular, the wireless company that supports self-expression nationwide.
Hunstman Center, Salt Lake City, where the Utes have had a tremendous advantage over the years in their winning percentage. Rick Barnes comes to visit Rick Majerus this time after a pretty demanding early schedule, starting off with those Wildcats.
Well, that start off there, and then it's again in The Alaskan Shootout, Gonzaga and Indiana got him, but this is a club that's right now, I think they have the seventh best record overall in the Big 12, and I'll talk about it later. The Big 12 this year, the best college basketball conference in the country, better than the ACC top to bottom.
Leaving it off there is Nick Jacobson for Osmondson. Left side, Jeff Johnson looking for Burgess posting up. He'll take the mid-range jumper. Royal Ivy let Jeff Johnson flash by him, and Jeff took it. We've got an injury, and that's going to hurt Texas. That ball was down the floor quickly, an easy basket for James Thomas, and Rick Barnes is wondering why Steve Wilmer brought that play to an end. It looks like Chris Burgess has badly turned his ankle.
Just when he finally gets healthy in Rick Majerus' system, he goes down with an ankle sprain. Again, this is a guy that has really flourished this year under Rick Majerus. He's scoring, he's rebounding, he's playing tough. See if we can keep an eye on it. He's right there at the left side of your screen underneath the rim. As he goes up, must have happened before that. Must have stepped on somebody.
He was dueling down there, it appeared, with Royal Ivy. May have gotten his sneaker on Ivy's foot. This is a guy that they tell us is playing better than he's ever played before. Our best post presence since the great Michael Doliak, who was one of three consecutive lottery picks Rick Majerus coached here in recent years, joining Keith Van Horn and Andre Miller, who had another typical Andre Miller game for the Cavaliers last night.
25-11. You and I sat here many nights and said Andre Miller is destined to be a star at the next level, but this is not good news for Ute fans, I can tell you, because this guy's been making about 7 out of every 10 shots he's attempted in a game. He's been playing tough. He's weathered through back problems and ankle problems before throughout his career. Again, he was part of that great recruiting class at Duke, Elton Brand and those kids several years ago.
Lance Allred, a 6'10 sophomore averaging 10 minutes a game, will step in and try to replace Burgess. And the way they're taking him to the locker room so slowly, he can't put any pressure at all on that ankle. Appears to be a very bad sign for Utah.
We've looked at every angle we can see, Bob, and just can't see him turning that ankle or anything. So I don't know if he got a bad step on it. But you can see that he's not putting any pressure at all on that right foot.
Freddie Williams runs the offense for Texas now. Owens a high pick. They check Sidmill Harrison at the timeout. A very good perimeter shooter. There's Thomas. He hits it from inside the arc. James Thomas, 4 points off the bench. Made the Big 12 all-freshman team a year ago when he averaged 7 points and 7 boards. And Freddie Williams with a backcourt foul.
Williams trying to get up and really put pressure on Eric Osmondson, the freshman point guard on the floor right now for Utah. Texas now with Williams in the lineup, they have 3 perimeter guys that can really turn the heat up on you. Barnes has had to been a little closer to the vest the first few games because of the lack of depth on the perimeter, but now he's got him back.
Jeff Johnson on top for his younger brother, Britton Johnson. Allred goes left wing, their other big fella. They've got a lot of size on this club. Here's Jacobson looking to penetrate. Contact, no call. He drains the three. Rick Barnes didn't complain about it until the shot went in.
Mountain West freshman of the year is Jacobson. He's probably their most consistent shooter, and he can do something off the bounce now, something that he couldn't do last year.
Freddie Williams going coast to coast and drawing the foul on Eric Osmondson.
Bob, all afternoon long, Texas is going to get up on you defensively. As a result, you've got to do something off of the dribble. This time, Jacobson with 2 bounces gets his feet set and jumps up and knocks it down. Texas is going to come at Utah all afternoon long, try to keep them out of running their motion and their sets.
Nick Jacobson gunning the threes. That one will put him up around 50%. He's what the coaches call a 180 guy. I'll tell you more about that. There aren't many of them in college basketball, or the pros for that matter. Freddie Williams makes the first free throw. TJ Ford coming back in for the shooter in a moment, if he makes it. Travis Spivey back in for Utah. Freddie Williams, they say he's the best defensive guard in the country. Now that's saying something, because one of the other best defensive guards in the nation is his teammate, Royal Ivy.
Yeah, well, he's certainly one of the better perimeter defenders in the Big 12, and now you're seeing the rotation that Rick Barnes has not had the luxury of using. Now Ford comes back in rested, and he's a ball of energy anyways, but especially when you can set him down 2 or 3 minute stretches, he goes back in and has it cranked up at level 10.
10-7, Texas. Penetration by Spivey. May go all the way. Travis Spivey with the finger roll. He's been to Georgia Tech, a brief stop at Iowa State, the JUCO ranks in the last 2 years here in Salt Lake City.
He's been really doubling and chasing that basketball when Ford has it coming off of a ball screen.
Look how they lay off TJ Ford, daring him to shoot a three. He's 1 for 10 this year. Owens improvising, losing it. Thomas can't hit. And a rebound underneath Chris Owens. He is so strong, never out of the play.
Bob, if you don't lace him to the top eyelet against the Texas bigs, they're going to chew you up. Thomas, one of those guys that wakes up in the morning thinking about, where's my next rebound? Where's my next rebound? That's how he plays.
Britton Johnson wakes up thinking, where's my next three? All Mountain West tournament, or rather conference preseason, the only Ute on that five-man squad. He is something else. There's TJ Ford. He can hit from inside the arc. He's shooting 51% overall.
Yep, just inside the arc is about where his range is right now. And you see Utah going underneath that ball screen. If that ball screen is set low, then Ford's going to have some open 15, 16-foot shots.
Spivey working this time against Sid Mill Harris. Jacobson lets it fly. Over the top, looks like a foul on Lance Allred of Utah. That'll be his first. Sunday night, the Saints continue their push to the playoffs. Ricky Williams, yeah, he played a little football Texas, didn't he? Leads the Saints attack against Marty Schottenheimer's tough Washington defense, who would love to spoil the Saints' preseason or postseason hopes. By the way, that game is tonight. Sunday night football, Saturday night version on ABC.
Lots of scenarios in that playoff picture right now, I can tell you that much. How about Texas last night? They win the Holiday Bowl without their freshman stud, Cedric Benson, who has a freshman over 1,000 yards rushing. First time ever for a freshman in Texas.
That may extend the Utah defense a little as TJ Ford hits the three, only his second three-point make of the year.
No, it's not going to extend them. They're going to feel like if there's TJ Ford shooting threes, they've done a good job. That's what Rick Majerus told his squad yesterday and this morning. He will not beat us from the three-point line.
Spivey in the corner, Trace Caton. He's got a good shooting eye, knocks down the three. He's shooting over 50% from three-point range this year.
Caton's now made 9 out of his last 12 from the three-point line. Very confident in that stroke.
TJ got a little too confident that time. Missing the three. Not what Barnes was looking for. Jacobson for three. He's got a couple of trays. And the Utes are gunning from long range to take the lead.
Great job by Spivey not to over-penetrate, and he didn't go too quick. He knew he had a shooter coming on the weak side. He waited for Jacobson to get his feet set, delivered it right on the money.
Crowd gets involved now. 8 minutes in. This one's going back the other way. Illegal pick by Brian Boddicker, who just checked in. So things going the Utes way now. Just over 8 minutes in, leading as usual at home.
I just want to do it right today.
Just watch your corner. Get all your men back here alive.
Your men are going to look to you to make the right decisions. Their lives depend on it.
No fear! Oh, yeah, right!
Space between the bullets and our firefight.
Okay! I can hear the bells ringing.
Waiting for you.
In Los Angeles, everywhere, January 18th.
Something amazing is happening. It will change the way you bake your cookies, sweeten your cereal, even drink your coffee. It's Splenda No Calorie Sweetener. It's made from sugar, so it tastes like sugar, but it's not sugar. It's Splenda No Calorie Sweetener. Pretty amazing, huh?
ABC's Monday Night Football Holiday Bash continues tonight. Ravens, Bucks, are you ready? Monday Night Football, tonight on ABC.
If ever there were a year the world needed to come together, this is the year, and this is the place.
On New Year's Eve, we're reaching out to the world again.
ABC 2002, Monday, starting at 6:30, 5:30 Central. Then the countdown continues. Live from Times Square, it's Dick Clark with today's hottest music.
What are you doing, New
Year? Catch Dick Clark's New Year's Rockin' Eve right after ABC 2002.
Utah, Chris Burgess out. We've got his report in a moment, but the Utes have hit four of their first 5 3-point shots.
Appreciate the play that Spivey makes with that basketball on the left side. You see how he didn't get in too big of a hurry? He knew he had Jacobson, a shooter, running the right side. So he kind of paced his dribble up the floor, waited for Jacobson to get his feet set, then boom, made the cross-court pass. How good it is to see Rick Majerus back, the sweater, the cup going, the whole thing on the sidelines. It took us about 5 seconds in yesterday's practice to know that the big guy was back, huh? He was barking and going.
They went for 3 hours plus yesterday afternoon, 24 hours before a day game. The bad news is Chris Burgess has a torn plantar fascia in his right foot. Won't return today. They expect him to be out for a few more games. Not a season-threatening injury at this time.
Look at Texas really get out in pressure. Look how high Utah is having to start their offense right now. Again, designed to make Utah do something off the dribble.
Jacobson, the left-handed scoop. Using the glass, but over the iron. And there's Phil Cullen, who's got a 93-mile-an-hour fastball when he pitches. And a nice little follow basket there. Boddicker. Took a while to get Boddicker into the game for Texas. There's a turnover. Utah up by three. We'll get it back. And the Longhorns and Rick Barnes will check Chris Owens back in. A little playing time a moment there for Deginald Erskine, who had been out with a separated shoulder for the last six games. So gradually this Texas club getting all of their personnel back. 8-0 run now by the Utes. Cullen almost knocking down the three. He's like Van Horn in the respect that he's a big guy who can step out there and shoot.
He'll get his shot anytime he wants because he's 6'9". He can shoot over the top of pretty good defensive position on that perimeter.
Trace Caton fighting in the ring, and he's fouling.
Utah going to really fight hard. You usually see a gamble and a lunge down there at the low block. That's the one thing you can't do. You got to play either solid from behind or solidly in front. You gamble at that low block position, you're either going to give up a layup or you're going to foul.
T.J. Ford lobs it over for Owens. The turnaround. Spivey reached in to get him. Travis knew it.
Utah, number 11.
David Hall, the lead official, good position right near that to make the call. He works with Scott Thornley and Steve Wilmer, three of the most well-respected officials in this part of the country.
Chris Owens is a hoss. This is the guy that Utah defensively today, when he's on that low block, they're either going to play completely in front of him or completely behind him. You do that because, number one, you're taller. You've got 6'10 and 6'11 kids to throw at him. But secondly, this guy understands angles as well as anybody in the country. He spreads out wide and low on that low block. He's a big, wide, low target. And if he gets the angle on you, boom, he finishes with quickness. Play in front of him, play behind him, and take the angle out of the game on him.
Off to a good start with 6 points and a rebound. He had a double-double at UNLV last Saturday, 18 points and 16 rebounds. High post, Britton Johnson, waiting for someone to weave. He takes it to the floor and travels before he can get the ball down.
Johnson probably their best perimeter driver, if you can believe that, for a kid 6'9 or 6'10. He's got great quick feet. You described him last year like a young colt out there at times, just all arms and legs moving with that basketball.
Johnson Ford on the perimeter, looking back door. Owens, Allred got up there with him to thwart that play. And now we've got Chris Owens down on the floor. Clutching the back of his right knee, maybe the low hamstring, not sure. Oh my.
How about that? The two interior studs for both clubs right now have gone down early in this game. See if we can see it. Owens gets bumped a little bit and gets him off balance. When he comes down, boy, it's hard to tell. Looks like that.
Yeah, he was sort of
right knee,
sort of twisting and turning, trying to reach back for the ball right there.
You know what? His foot came down on Allred's just enough to throw his ankle and his knee a little bit cockeyed on him. That kid right there is a warrior. You just talk about different warriors across the country. Chris Owens is right there with the best of them. I love this Texas team if they stay healthy. That's what we're looking at right now. But you look at that Big 12 right now with Kansas ranked third, Oklahoma State ranked fifth, Missouri ranked 10th, Oklahoma ranked 14th with Jabari Brown now in the lineup for Kelvin Sampson down there in Norman. That Big 12 is loaded.
Texas out of the Big 12, Utah Mountain West in front of a deathly silent Hunstman Center in Salt Lake City. Our ABC coverage today from UBS Payne Weber as we get ready for conference play to start in the next week and a half or so in college basketball. Chris Owens still on the floor. Brian Farr, the Texas trainer, tending to him with help from his staff. Chris Ogden, a teammate now, coming down to help.
Bob, he's got an NBA body. Said earlier that he has always, throughout his career, defended like an All-American, rebounded like an All-American. He's now scoring more like an All-American, primarily because of T.J. Ford on the floor with him. But everyone has to hope right now that that's nothing more than just a sprain at worst.
I'm going to walk Chris Owens right down to the visitor's locker room, leaving the floor with about the same lack of power that Chris Burgess did 7 or 8 minutes ago. Double-figure scores, good rebounders. Owens, the shot blocker, the go-to guy. Chris Burgess, we know, is not coming back today. And that's a very nervous drink of water Rick Barnes is taking right now.
Well, it's amazing how many ball games that Rick Barnes won last year. Won 25 games. They did not shoot well as a team. Right around 41% for the year, and they didn't have a true point guard. But he's gotten it done throughout his career defensively. That's what they'll rely on right now without Chris Owens, their best inside scorer.
Here's Spivey. He did a little clear out for him there. He just spread the floor, and he went to work. And that's a couple of times the Utah guards haven't finished what they started.
That's what that motion offense gives you, though, Bob. You keep that floor spread with four on the perimeter, one on the inside, and then attack those driving angles. Spivey's pretty good at getting to the rim.
On the wing for Mouton. Inside the arc, he's short. Great rebound at the offensive side. And then it's picked up by Freddie Williams. Boddicker for three. Big guy can shoot out there and rims out on him. And we've got a Texas foul, apparently against James Thomas. That'll be his first.
James Thomas, first drive.
Thomas, a big force off the bench at 6'8", 220. 8 points, five rebounds a game.
Boddicker, number 33 for Texas. He's the wild card, not only today, but through the rest of the season. He's their best scorer. You've got to remember, he was a high school All-American, one of the three that Texas has had in their history of basketball. Ford, Boddicker, and Chris Black a few years ago.
Allred, little 15-footer, down it goes. That's a bonus for Majerus, who doesn't often get scoring from that big fella, averaging 3 points and one rebound a game. He's going to play a lot more than his normal 10 minutes today. Boddicker is called the missing piece of our puzzle by the Texas coaching staff. Here's T.J. Ford. A little hesitation. And the rebound finds Allred. Good work down there by Britton Johnson. Utah by three. Chris Owens injured and out of the game for Texas. We'll wait for a report on him. Johnson in traffic. Improvises. Banks it home. And Britton Johnson with 5 points today.
That was great footwork by Britton Johnson because Texas sealed the play pretty well. They've left just enough of a gap. Boom, for him to step through and get to the rim.
Longhorns down the floor, 4.5 minutes without a field goal. And the dump down to James Thomas, a Utah five.
Utah
to be on Lance Allred, his second.
Britton Johnson's a tough matchup because he can drive from the perimeter. Look at that. The little up and under move, and then he's got the height at the end of the play to finish at 6'10". He leads this team in free throw attempts right now because he's so active on the offensive end. He and guys like Phil Cullen are a headache to match up against because of their size and their versatility. Blue Blazer players.
Good all. I was wondering how long into our season you would drop a Blue Blazer on us.
You got to wait till you get a Blue Blazer guy on the floor to talk about.
Here's James Thomas. Not a bad free throw shooter, right around 70%.
He gets one rebound every 3 minutes he's on the floor. Now, you love a guy that accepts his role, and again, all he thinks about from the time he leaves the team hotel and gets to the arena is, Where's my next rebound? Where's my next rebound? That's to what the mentality this guy brings to the floor.
Well, Texas knew it coming in. He averaged 13 boards a game in prep school up at Hargrave, Virginia. Big 12 all-freshman team last year, averaging 7 or better. And the Longhorns back to within 3, 8:15 to go before halftime. Jeff Johnson barely keeping possession, getting it back now from Jacobson. They've got Brandon Mouton out on him. By the way, Texas 8-for-8 at the line so far. Tough pass. Oh, and it did hit Jeff Johnson. Little brother, Britton, tried to get one down to him. A high-risk pass and a turnover by Utah.
You know what? He waited too late. Jeff Johnson was open the first two steps of the back cut, but then by the third step, the defender had caught up with him. Got to deliver it, boom, when he's open. That's what T.J. Ford understands as a freshman. Where to pass the ball and when to pass the ball.
Catch, a shoot, and not in for Freddie Williams. But he will make them better. Horns hanging in despite the lack of Owens. It's Utah by 3.
I'm a mama's boy. I pity the fool who ain't one. Mama misses you. So when you call her collect, dial 1-800-COLLECT. It'll save her a buck or two. Mama loves saving me with 1-800-COLLECT. 1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two.
People across the nation are getting the message. For great year-end values, amazing selection. Toyota-thon 02. Right now, you'll find everything you've been looking for in the all-new redesigned Camry. Sleeker, more powerful, better than ever before. Which says a lot, given that Camry's been the best-selling car in America the last 4 years. Toyota-thon 02. Password, value.
Welcome to United Online, joining together Net Zero, Juno, and millions of people who have stopped paying high internet bills. Now you can have great connections, fast page loads, instant message compatibility, and at only $9.95, it's less than half the price of AOL. There's never been a better time to switch. Call 877-ONLY-995 or visit netzero.net or juno.com. Additional phone charges may apply.
I'm a mama's boy. I pity the fool who ain't one. Mama misses you. So when you call her collect, dial 1-800-COLLECT. It'll save her a buck or two. Mama loves saving me with 1-800-COLLECT. 1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two.
There's no place.
There's no place like home.
There's no place like home.
Somebody help me! Up!
Rose Red, Sunday, January 27th on ABC.
John Saunders here in the studio with this update. Missouri facing DePaul at DePaul, and they don't get a body on Andre Brown. Watch as the ball goes to the hoop. Brown reads it, goes up, jams it down as DePaul increases their lead. Right now, time is running out. About 11 seconds left. DePaul up by 3. Bob and Jimmy. All right, John, thank you. And if you go by the preseason prognostications, that could be a huge upset today.
How about that for Conference USA and DePaul? Who's better? In my opinion right now, it's the Big 12. You look, they have 4 teams that are ranked in the top 15 in the country or better. The ACC only has 3. Texas not even on this list right now in the Big 12. This is overall records. Texas Tech no longer an easy win, especially in Lubbock. But I really love the Big 12. They have Oklahoma State, who I saw fight back from a 32-10 deficit at Arkansas last week. Kansas and Oklahoma are all legitimate Final Four teams. If you look at the ACC, I think only Duke and Maryland are that kind of quality. Top to bottom, Big 12 better than the ACC this year.
Well, how about Maryland at Oklahoma last week? No contest, if you want to go by that sort of comparison. But that DePaul Missouri thing is huge, because nobody's talking about DePaul in Conference USA in terms of challenging for even a division championship. What a big win that could be for Pat Kennedy.
How about that league? Cincinnati, Memphis, DePaul now, Louisville, not to mention all the South Floridas and Charlottes of the world in that thing.
There are some tough places to play in that league. Here's Britton Johnson way out high. Over the right side for Jacobson. Johnson thought about the shot in the corner. Shot clock at four. Oh, my. From way downtown, Nick Jacobson. You could hang an Olympic ski jump on that long-range bomb.
Wow. Locked and loaded. That's how he enters the contest. Jacobson is a shooter.
Clocks the rebound, a basket, and a foul. Well, trying to stay with him, Cameron Colford giving some defensive time for Rick Majerus at the other end.
Look at Jacobson again. He knows that shot clock's winding down. That's from about 26, 27 feet. A pure shooter right now. The answer for Texas on the other end is how many offensive rebounds they're able to get in this first half. This is going to be their sixth or seventh offensive board against a club that takes a lot of pride keeping you off the offensive glass. That's that toughness and physical matchup that Utah has to match right now.
3-point play for Jason Klotz. Chris Owens is out for the rest of this game with a right knee injury. Longhorns will have a look at him when they get back to Austin tomorrow. They're spending the night here before they go back to campus on Sunday.
Utah strong with that basketball on the perimeter. You see him catching it, jerking that thing down low, getting in that basic third grade triple threat position. Important against pressure defense like Texas is putting on him.
Like we have a foul on Texas.
Foul. Texas number three.
It'll be on James Mouton. I'm sorry, Brandon Mouton. That'll be his first. 6'5 sophomore from Lafayette, Louisiana. 6.5 to go first half. And the Utes on top by three.
Utah has not scored yet off their out-of-bounds plays, but they're one of the top two or three teams in the country at executing from the out-of-bounds spot and getting an easy bucket on you if you're not ready.
Johnson in trouble. Oh, great look. That was almost a pickup and a slam. Royale Ivy snuffed it out, but he didn't get there in time to make the stop. He did get there in time to foul Britton Johnson.
Smart play by Johnson. He saw that his man was overplayed from about 20 feet out, so he took one step higher, and then boom, gets the back cut. You're not going to see the setup step by Johnson. There it was, a little right foot plant. That's setting his man up and then cutting hard right down the middle. Just like you draw it up.
Britton Johnson rims it out. Little catch and shoot off the inbounds play. James Thomas, the Texas rebound. TJ Ford up the floor. Running down to the 6-minute mark on this Longhorn possession. Royale Ivy has not scored yet. Some of the Texas guys were telling us yesterday, this is a very slick floor to play on here in Salt Lake City. Straight ahead to Klotz. Had a good look, and Britton Johnson, the Utah rebound.
Got to make it. Klotz was the screener. They stepped out to help, so he slid right to the front of the rim and missed a four-footer.
Texas has out-rebounded Utah, 12-8 so far. Whistle away from the ball. Phil Cullen fouled by Jason Klotz. That'll be his second.
Foul.
Bob, we've seen the height factor for Utah over the years. Get teams in foul trouble. They continually run the floor. They get to the high percentage spots on the floor where they're bigs. A lot of times you're forced to foul them to stop them.
17 fouls by Texas. Brian Boddicker back for the Longhorns. Look at this. Utah has not shot a free throw yet. Their first will come from Phil Cullen, who spent the summer with the Everett Aqua Sox, the single-A ball club of the Seattle Mariners. He's a 6'9 pitcher with a 94-mile-an-hour sinking fastball. But he's got plenty of arc on the free throw. Third point of the day.
He is probably the wild card guy off the Utah bench. He comes in this ball game only averaging 5, but he's capable of being a 12, 13-point scorer because of his versatility.
Majerus would have loved his answer today. When I asked Phil, what do you have other than your fastball? He said a jump shot.
Yeah, he's right.
I'm thinking slider, curve. TJ Ford a jump stop. Ivy comes crashing in. And Royale Ivy simply wanted the ball more than anybody else right there.
Great point. Right now, Texas is winning in the battle of who has the biggest Valentine, and that's what it boils down to on the offensive glass. Gets him 2 points because of it.
Royale Ivy the basket. Horns hang within 3. Running down toward the 5-minute mark, first half. Big 12 in conference. Bash, Ravens and Bucks. Keyshawn Johnson of the Buccaneers awaiting the Baltimore Ravens. Expect playoff intensity. Clubs are desperate for a win. Trying to sneak into that postseason tonight.
Baltimore wins, they're in. A lot of talk today about Rick Pitino returning to Rupp Arena. Now, I used to coach at Kentucky. I understand that Kentucky-Louisville scenario, it wouldn't matter if George Bush could be coaching at Louisville today, and they would boo him when he entered the arena. That's the animosity. Forget about his Rick Pitino. It's Louisville versus Kentucky. That thing's overrated right now.
Well, the fact that they're just over an hour apart, leaving one for a while, coming back to the other, and maybe the most insane basketball state in the country. Ivy stripped away. Nick Jacobson, some slick hands right there. Here's Spivey.
Utah runs really well as a unit. All five guys in motion as soon as they secured that basketball, and this is off the secondary break right here.
That was a great look for Trace Caton. Jeff Johnson, the back iron rebound. Always looking for the cutter. Jeff Johnson takes on Mouton. Goes down to the baseline, draws a foul on him. Jeff Johnson has a little Alex Jensen in him, a guy who was a senior here a couple of years ago who Jimmy and I admired greatly as one of the smartest players we ever saw play at this level.
Jeff Johnson's important in this game because of his ability to do what got him to the free throw stripe. He can put the ball on the floor and make his own play, get his own shot. Texas more athletic on the defensive end, matching up with him, so you've got to do something other than your system at times, and that's exactly what Jeff Johnson did.
At the first one, 3 points for Jeff today. Freddie Williams back for Texas. Jeff Johnson and his brother Britton, the fifth brother set to play here at Utah for Rick Majerus, but the first to ever play together. There's another half of a brother duo on the floor right now, Trace Caton. His older brother Ben was pretty solid here. And Jeff Johnson with the two free throws, 4 points on the day, and the Utes lead by five.
Well, Utah defending awfully well, also running from offense to defense as a unit. That time they took away the penetration ability of Williams by the secondary help defenders being in place.
Longhorns clearing out. Freddie Williams to the glass, high off the glass, and Trace Caton fouls him in the act.
Foul Utah. But Williams really brings something to the floor for Rick Barnes' squad. Talked about his ability to come in and spur T.J. Ford. He can also play him together. So now you have two guys that can break you down off the dribble. He's another ferocious perimeter defender.
Longhorns 9 of 9 at the line. Last year, Freddie Williams, 4 points, 1 rebound in 28 games, started 5 times. The J.C. guy at Mississippi Delta. He really completes them coming off the bench. Now the problem is health of Chris Owens. Caton sits down. Jeff Johnson back in for Utah after a quick breather. Freddie Williams, a Georgia kid from Evans, Georgia.
Chris Owens and T.J. Ford are the two most important guys for Rick Barnes. We've seen that Texas offense go a little bit stagnant in the half-court set because they're used to the offense running through Chris Owens' hands. When he's not down that low block, it completely throws him out of rhythm. They're a herky-jerky team anyways on offense because of the style that Ford plays.
4 minutes to go, first half. Teams are trading twos here. Spivey all the way, can't finish. They've had several opportunities deep for their guards. Longhorns are running, two Utes get back. That looked like a travel, and Scott Thornley whistles him for it. Freddie Williams shuffling his feet around and turning the ball over. The under 4 minute timeout with 3:50 to go. Rick Majerus and the Utes over the Horns by three.
People across the nation are getting the message. For great year-end values, amazing selection, Toyotathon 02. Now get 0% APR financing on some of Toyota's most popular models, like Corolla, the rugged V8 Tundra, the versatile 4Runner, and the roomy Sienna. Hurry, don't miss this incredible opportunity. Toyotathon 02, password value.
From Claudia Rodriguez to her childhood friend.
K2 Construction and their number one supplier.
Grandpa William and his grandson Billy.
Chang Lin and her great-great aunt.
Sergeant Peter Kozak and his fiancée Deb.
To all the people who can't be together, from all the people who bring you together, happy holidays.
Timmy Welsh and a Mr. S. Claus.
Hey, Ed's Gel is gonna clean up your act.
with Edge Clean Shave Gel.
Edge Clean.
Edge Clean's got a built-in facial cleanser that helps lift dirt and oil every time you lather. To help lift dirt and oil every time you shave.
Edge Clean Complete.
So clean up your act with Edge Clean Shave Gel.
Yo. Two six packs and a big bag of ice. Didn't even get to bite, but the brew tastes nice. Nice. Back to the stick it in the fridge, stick it in the fridge, stick it in the fridge, stick it in the fridge. A la Cuba Frigia, a la Cuba Frigia, a la Cuba Frigia. I'm kind of thirsty. A la Cuba Frigia, a la Cuba Frigia.
ABC's New Year celebration continues when Florida battles ACC champ Maryland, the FedEx Orange Bowl. Wednesday night at 8, 5 Pacific on ABC.
Getting this update now between the DePaul and Missouri game. DePaul holds on to win at home, 63-62. The final, Brown, who had a huge rebound putback earlier, we showed you, with 18 points.
Thank you, John Saunders. What a huge win that is for Conference USA. A DePaul club pick to finish sixth in their own division ahead of only East Carolina. Our story today here in Salt Lake City, Chris Burgess leaves 4.5 minutes into the game with a bad foot injury. He'll be out for several games. And Chris Owens, about 5.5 minutes later, a right knee injury that'll knock him out for the rest of today. A lot of free throws for the Longhorns so far. They're down by three. They're going to set up a little three-quarter court pressure here, trying to do some trapping. Britton Johnson just missing on the three and the rebound. Loose ball picked up, Freddie Williams.
Texas goes to that full court press to try to stay out of having to defend Utah in the half court set for the entire possession. Trying to buy a little time and slow Utah down some.
Fans thought Boddicker double dribble. Royale Ivy with a running hook shot. And four for Royale, the outstanding defensive player.
We talk all we want to about Ford and Owens, and Ivy's the most consistent guy from Rick Barnes so far this season. He's an open jump shooter. He can take you to the rim and finish. He's a lock-you-up defender. Told me last night at dinner his goal to be the Big 12 defender of the year. That's the mentality he brings to the floor.
Coaches call him a pit bull at the defensive end. There's Cullen. Dumping it down. Johnson, great service. Jeff Johnson took a hit on the way up and couldn't quite finish.
Talk about Ivy's ability to turn the corner, and the help defense right there for Utah is just a step slow rotating over. As a result, Ivy, with his size at 6'4", can get to the rim and finish in traffic. I love the way this kid plays the game. He really developed last year when he was forced to play the point for Rick Barnes. Started 24 games as a freshman. Really developed his perimeter game.
After the Freddie Williams foul, Jeff Johnson another free throw. Utah living at the line lately. No field goals in the last 4 minutes plus, but doing okay at the line after not shooting a free throw for about the first 13 minutes of this first half. We're under the 3 minute mark to go. Utes by three. TJ Ford narrowly avoiding a travel. Here's Ivy, baseline left, switches to the right hand. Loose ball, finds the horns. Back iron, the three misfired there by Sid Mill Harris. And Phil Cullen on the floor, but he can't get the ball back for his club. And Rick Majerus is irate. John Saunders, Digger Phelps with our halftime report coming up next. A look at the highlights of that number 10 Missouri upset at DePaul. San Diego State from the Mountain West at number one Duke in the ACC, and Rick Pitino's return as he goes to Lexington with his Louisville Cardinals today. Boddicker short with the three. Thomas had it. Knocked away by Utah. Ball was out of bounds over the baseline, so Texas, for Majerus, a possession that will never end, will get it back again.
Texas with 10 offensive rebounds in this first half. Very uncharacteristic of Utah to give up that many.
Sid Mill Harris, a pretty good outside shooter. He hit 5 of 9 threes against Arizona. And he threw up an air ball there. Phil Cullen for three. There's his extra dimension. Seven for him off the bench.
Another great read by Travis Spivey, the point guard, to know that I've got a shooter trailing me in the break.
Britton Johnson rejecting T.J. Ford. An emphatic shot block.
Look at Spivey right there. He didn't get in a hurry again. He knew one of our better three-point shooters is trailing me in the break. Just drop it off to him. Cullen caught it and then rhythm. Perfect shot for him. He was really a weapon at 6'9 and a half to match up with.
Boddicker from Mouton. Looking to trap his Utah. Somebody's open. It's T.J. Ford. Mid-range jumper. Boy, he steps inside the arc. He hardly misses. He's shooting 51% overall.
See where he shot that ball from, don't you? Just one step inside that three-point line. He's not a great shooter, but he doesn't take bad shots like a lot of freshman point guard the country will do to
you. T.J. Ford, 3 out of 9 so far. And James Thomas trying to keep up with Phil Cullen. Ran right into the screener, Travis Spivey there. And for James Thomas, it'll be his second.
Bob, one thing that Utah does year in and year out, they screen as well as you can teach it. And when they go screen, they become a big screener. A lot of teams, when they go screen, they're too small. These guys spread out wide, and they're a big target. As a result, look at Spivey. Boom, seems spread out. That's a big target to run into, and this time it works.
Travis Spivey, 73% at the line. Started the last 19 games for Utah last year. They made a great rush to finish 10-4 in the Mountain West and tied BYU and Wyoming for the league championship. And they got knocked out by New Mexico in the first round of the conference tournament. Went to the NIT, lost to Memphis in a lackluster effort, and that broke a streak of 6 consecutive NCAAs here.
I'm telling you, the secondary defense, shadow, whatever you want to call it, on T.J. Ford is excellent right now for Utah.
That's going back the other way, a charge on Royale Ivy. An official from each wing blew the whistle there. Minute 10 to go, first half. Utah trying to move out to a big lead here before halftime. They've led by as many as 6. On top by 5 at the moment. That 3 just rimmed out by Jacobson. Every one of their threes has at least gone in or hit the rim twice today. They have really shot the 3-ball well so far, hitting 6 of 11. T.J. Ford has missed 3 in a row out there after hitting his first. And as Jimmy mentioned, they'll let him take that shot all day.
They continue to go underneath that ball screen that they're setting by Ford.
Utah timeout.
Have those open 18, 19 footers. They will not let him continue to have 14 and 15 footers. It all depends on how high the ball screen is being set for Texas right now. Determines how Utah guards it. I was talking earlier about the shadow defense on T.J. Ford. One-on-one, you're not going to stop this guy. Watch as he brings the ball up. All 5 guys are going to have him in vision. Look at the bigs right now for Utah. 31 and 11, those are the 2 guys that are responsible for stopping that dribble penetration. Great job right there by Britton Johnson, who's not assigned to T.J. Ford, to shadow him and be that help defender. That's how you stop a great penetrator like T.J. Ford, and they did it to perfection on that last trip.
T.J. Ford, 3 of 10. But listen to this, 1 assist. Travis Spivey, 1 out of 5 for Utah, 3 assists. So no assist pace whatsoever for T.J. Ford today, and I think he got that first one pretty early after the opening tap.
Bob, he'll get 4 or 5 assists a game in transition, and Utah has taken that out of his game so far.
Shot clock approaching 10, final 20 minutes of the first half.
Texas has spent a lot of time in this ball game on the defensive end of the floor.
Spivey for Britton Johnson. Shovels to his brother Jeff. Shot clock at 2 from the corner. Oh my!
Are you kidding me?
He didn't make that, did he? Timeout, Rick Barnes. 8 seconds to go. An amazing 3-point shot from Jeff Johnson out of the corner.
They need to put 2 up for that last one on the board. I mean, the recognition, first of all, to know that the thing's ticking down on me. I got to get some extra elevation on it because the defender's with me. and nothing but the bottom. Watch the clock. The shot clock's at 4, 3. He knows I'm going to have to get this thing up. The defender's right in my face, so I got to put some extra elevation on it. Boom. Mm. I mean, you won't see a ski jump in the Winter Olympics go off any better than this thing come February in Salt Lake. Wow.
They've added some time to the clock. It was 8.0. They've made it 9.1. And look at Utah, 21 points off three-point shots in the first half.
While they came into this game shooting 19 or 20 three-point shots a game, they make 7 or 8. That's a big part of their offense. You have to defend it if you're going to beat the Utes. They did everything they were supposed to on that time, but just got the bounce.
ABC's NCAA College Basketball presented by UBS Payne Weber. 9.1 seconds to go as the Longhorns bring it up. On the wing, Sidmill Harris, barely nicking iron. Cullen knocked it away from his man. They can't get it to Jeff Johnson quickly enough. What a first half shooting for Utah. They don't always live and die by the three, but they're living pretty with the three today.
Great three-point shooting by Utah in the first half. However, the big guy in the sweater, the first thing he'll talk about, keep them off the offensive glass. That's how Texas has stayed in this thing so far.
And at the half, the running Utes of Utah enjoy their biggest lead. 40-32 as the Mountain West has the current advantage here in Utah over the Big 12.
NCAA basketball presented by UBS Payne Weber on ABC Sports. Brought to you by the United States Postal Service and Edge Clean Shaving Gel. It helps lift dirt and oil every time you shave. We'll be back with the halftime show after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
You're just begging for heartburn, aren't you?
What are you doing?
Forget about these. Here, Norman turned me on to Pepsi Complete.
And?
And I tried one. One. That's all it took.
One?
Mm-hmm. Complete works fast like those, but lasts like those. Just one controls acid all day.
Lasts all day.
Nothing else like it. Where are you going?
Sausages, anyone?
Pepsid Complete. Just one, and heartburn's done.
Yeah, I remember that day. 32 against 2. Slow day for yours truly. I'll let Jack handle these lurkers. Once in a while, I throw him a bone. I let him have these ones, too. He's been a little rusty, so,
Hi, Jack.
Hey. I was just talking about you.
A new legacy is born. Rated E for everyone.
The thrill of victory.
Go!
And the agony of defeat.
Down goes Frazier!
Celebrate 40 years of ABC's Wide World of Sports tonight.
Every Sunday night on ABC, Sydney Bristow has a new alias.
They are gonna kill us both.
Turn her on.
I want to turn him in.
Tune it up.
What you think you know, you don't know.
And jump in.
This is a setup.
Every week, a new mission.
I'm gonna make sure you pay.
Alias, Sundays at 9, 8 Central on ABC.
With a month to go until the big show, come cheer on America's best skiers as they put it all on the line to win the U.S. Ski Team Gold Cup. Witness firsthand the joy and triumph as the winners are awarded a ticket to return to Salt Lake this February. Watch alpine athletes speed around gates, freestyle skiers take to the skies, and cross-country men and women test their endurance December 29th through the 31st at Park City Mountain Resort, Snow Basin, Soldier Hollow, and Deer Valley. Events are free and open to the public. Cheer loud for those wearing red, white, and blue. U.S. Ski Team Gold Cup, where champions prove it. What does 0+0+0% equal?
Your Park City Auto Dealers.
John Meekum Dodge, Chrysler Jeep.
Mike Hale Chevrolet.
Crandall Ford Mercury.
Get 0% APR interest financing on Ford, Mercury, Dodge, Chrysler, Jeep, and Chevy at your Park City Auto Dealers.
15 minutes up Parley's Canyon.
Crossed I-80 from the Outlet Mall.
Hurry, zero will be zero, nada, gone, soon.
If you're looking for a Ford, Mercury, Chevrolet, Oldsmobile, Chrysler, Jeep, or Dodge, come up and see your Park City dealers.
Used People, Sunday at 2 on 4 Utah.
Great three-point shooting by Utah. They hit 7 threes in 12 attempts in the first half, and they lead Texas by a score of 40-32. Good shooting by the Utes up and down. Nick Jacobson, 3 out of 5 from three-point range. He's got 9 points. Jeff Johnson has 9. He's hit both of his free throws. Leading the way for the Longhorns at the half, 7 points and 1 rebound for T.J. Ford, but only 1 assist. It's Utah by 8 here in Salt Lake City at the half.
So, how's your dad doing?
That's what I really wanted to talk to you about. I think that we're going to have to bring him up here and find a care facility for him.
We talked about this.
Mm-hmm.
You know the money's there. You should be able to find a really nice place for
him. I hate the walls. Hello?
Hey, Dad. Yeah, we're meeting Mike over at Payne Weber this afternoon. Talk about our business plan. You're going to be there, right? You drove all that way to save $50 on new tires, did you? Hey, Dad, you know, you could afford to buy a whole new car.
It's not on the lake, but it's close. Oh, it's a beautiful house. Of course, they can't afford it. They just got married. Well, Tom and I would like to help them out. I was just looking at our account.
So, Ben, what's getting the most buzz at this year's Tech Expo?
Well, Sarah, everyone is still talking about the mobile internet, but the really great usable stuff.
You just got over the holidays and you've about run out of money. The last thing you need now is to run out of minutes. Well, now you don't have to. Sign up with Singular Wireless and you'll get unlimited talk time during nights and weekends on plans starting at just $19.99. You'll also get a deal on a Nokia phone, and that is pretty cool. Singular Wireless, what do you have to say?
Here's to the go-to guys for doing all the work while someone else gets all the glory. Enter the Ford Make the Tough Call and Win sweepstakes at bcsfootball.com or call 1-800-468-FORD. Watch the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl January 1st on ABC. Spot the tough play of the game and you can get the glory of owning a Ford truck. Thanks, big guy.
Patrick Waugh, Sackett Geisman, Colorado, Detroit. Even I'll be watching that one on ABC.
The NHL on ABC. Next Saturday at 3 Eastern, New Pacific.
The Running Utes of Utah looking for their 5th consecutive win. Texas looking to make it 6 in a row, but they trail at halftime 40-32. John Saunders alongside of Digger Phelps. Both of these teams kind of stumbled out of the gate. 2-3 for Texas, 3-3 for Utah, but they've both got it going now.
Both got to go now, but you got to have your big guys in the paint, and we'll see what happens in the first half when you lose two premier front line players. This really is a setback for Utah, and as we look at Texas.
Yeah, Burgess and Owens both knocked out, and of course, they'll hope to get an update. Owens, it looked like the ankle, but maybe the knee as well. He was holding that. The number one team in the nation, Duke, facing San Diego State and Steve Fisher. Steve Fisher, though, has won his last two games against Duke. But at Cameron, watch them move the ball around. Jason Williams knocks down a three-pointer. That's what they do so well.
Automatic. Anytime you say any rhythm, everything finds out. Okay, let's go, Mr. Dunleavy, your turn. Another three. Duke comes out, but San Diego State doesn't go away in the first half. It becomes 25-24.
Yeah, here is Randy Holcomb. Dunks off of the miss right there. Nobody gets a body on him. You don't see Duke do that too often. Got it. Within a couple, but then Dunleavy again, knocking down another three-pointer.
Very consistent coming off the screen. Duke, good defensive pressure last 5 minutes, half to blow this to double figures. And when they come out in the second half, it'll be the same thing. Defensive intensity, get this thing over with. First game since 11-day break, since they beat Kentucky in overtime, the Jimmy V Classic.
Yeah, Cameron Crazies aren't there as well, so it's not quite the same atmosphere. Marquette coming off their first loss of the season, facing Wake Forest. Hicks moves it around and knocks down a three-pointer. Then Dwayne Wade. We'll get the pass in transition as Marquette trying to make this thing close. It's 52-35. They trailed by as many as 19. Ben Blankson, not firing blanks. Wide open. Buries a three. Marquette now within 5. And then Wade will drive from the wing for the reverse. And the game is tied at 57 apiece, a 22-5 run.
14-0 in that last run. When you look now inside, Josh Howard goes to the paint. Finds Antoine Scott. Big slam dunk. Put it up 4.
One last chance, though, for Marquette. The shot from outside, no good. Wade gets the rebound. Second chance is no good. Dawson comes down with the rebound, and Wake Forest holds on for the 63-59 win. Marquette losing to Wisconsin. Now Wake Forest, their first two losses of the season.
Wake Forest coming back, winning this game after losing to St. John's in the Garden last weekend. They've got to get ready. They're at Carolina, North Carolina, on the road next Saturday in Chapel Hill.
Josh Howard, double-double, 10 points and 11 rebounds. Louisville facing Kentucky, and this is the big news on the day. Making his return for so many victories there in Lexington, the hug for his former assistant, Tubby Smith. Both guys, tremendous coaches, both guys with national championships. Marquise Estill, nobody gets a body on this guy, and he jams this one down. Kentucky up early, but if you're a Kentucky fan, this is a nightmare, because the longer Louisville hangs around, the more chance they have.
This is the pressure really on Kentucky. You take a look at Tubby Smith as well as his team. They come back, have a great game against Duke in the Meadowlands, losing in overtime. Win against Indiana on the road. Now you figure, all right, let's spank Kentucky. Let's spank Rick Pitino. Pitino says, come yell at me. You guys go out and play. And they didn't. That's why this is a low-scoring game. Pitino's hanging tough. And believe me, if they pull this off, because 2 years from now he's going to have a better team when he gets his recruits in, this will really be a nightmare in Lexington.
They're going to face each other every year, so there's going to be the controversy come up every year. But you almost get the feeling, and it seems a bit unfair to Tubby Smith. He's done such a great job there. He won a national championship. Rick Pitino won a national championship. You wonder if Tubby gets the credit he deserves.
Yes, he does. I think the fact is that now that he's established himself, the way this team's coming around, Cliff Hawkins in that backcourt now being their legit point guard, I really think Kentucky's a team that's going to really challenge the Florida to the Southeastern Conference title and make sure that they may get a shot at a number one seed in the NCAA tournament. But on the other side of it, Rick Pitino knows, hey, I'm myself, I coach, I know how to do this. And in Conference USA, forget this game this afternoon once it's over, he's going to be a threat to Memphis as well as DePaul, who's hot, as well as to Cincinnati. So Pitino is Pitino, but Tubby still has the respect that he deserves.
I like the point you make also about Pitino taking the pressure off his kids. It definitely makes a difference. Missouri now trying to avoid losing for the third consecutive time this year and facing a DePaul team. Patrick Joseph Kennedy needed a victory in this one, and Andre Brown came to play for him. After the turnover, Brown comes down, grabs the ball, jams it in, DePaul up by two. And then this time on the lob, Sawyer finding Brown, up, two-handed, 10-point lead. Missouri tries to come back, led by Kareem Rush.
Well, this is one of the threes they make, but that's been the problem. They try to shoot too many threes, and they're not making them. DePaul had easy points in transition, especially when they got the ball inside to Mr. Andre Brown, who really made things happen. 18 big points, big win for Pat Kennedy. They won on the road last week against Temple, and now Missouri, after losing at home to Iowa, losing to Illinois and St. Louis, now losing in Chicago to DePaul. Quinn Snyder knows he's got problems as he gets ready to go into his conference. Three straight losses
after winning the first nine. DePaul, meanwhile, has reeled off four consecutive victories. Mississippi State over Tulane. There's about 4 minutes left in this one, 70-62. Georgetown facing UCLA.
Uh-oh.
A matchup of two ranked teams, but it did not look that way early. Matt Barnes lines up a three. 8-4 was the lead. Then Barnes again with another three.
The problem is Georgetown cannot shoot. They don't know who to find. You can't leave anybody open on the Bruins. They love to shoot it. They blow this thing out open early. And you've got to understand, Georgetown is not a perimeter shooting team. And UCLA just decided, let's go, get on the glass. Dan Gadzurek punishing the Hoyas in the paint. And when you look at the Hoyas, John, they got to find some shooters.
I think in the tank was right.
Tank.
When he said it the first time, he meant to say paint. Georgetown's on a little bit of a run. Craig Eschrick has just collected a technical foul. Now, keep in mind, coming up tonight, it's a special version of Monday Night Football, Super Bowl champion Baltimore Ravens against the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, an important game for both teams. But Warren Sapp knows this is the end of the line.
We like to tend to think we raise our ball games in December anyway, because December is the month that they'll remember. And that's the month where you make your most strides going into the playoffs and building momentum into the playoffs. And that's where we're at right now. We have to build momentum. We have to put ourselves in a good frame of mind going into the playoffs. And no bigger challenge than the world champions in your house.
Special edition of Monday Night Football live tonight, 9 o'clock Eastern time, the Ravens and the Buccaneers. Stick around. We'll continue with more of Halftime in a moment.
Now anyone can be a digital DJ. With the Intel Pentium 4 processor, the center of your digital world.
One blustery autumn Sunday, two warriors hunker down in the fury of battle.
For the win! Interception!
With one crushing blow, momentum turned. As the stalwart Viking mounted a final aerial assault, the battered warrior could only watch his hopes of victory vanish. And in defeat, learned dignity and grace.
NFL 2K2, rated E for everyone.
For great New Year's Day tradition, turn to ABC. The festivities begin at 11 a.m. Eastern with the Tournament of Roses Parade presented by Metabolite. 1 Eastern, Tennessee takes on Michigan in the Capital One Florida Citrus Bowl. At 4:30 Eastern, the Bowl Championship Series kicks off when Colorado faces Oregon in the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. 8 Eastern, Illinois battles LSU in the Nokia Sugar Bowl. The place to be on New Year's Day is ABC.
It's an inconvenience, and it's not fun. It's not like buying a car that was fun. No one likes to take time out of their life to get their car fixed. No one. Our collision repair center is the best one in the state. The technology today will allow us to fix your car better than factory specifications. If you wreck your car, you need to come and see us. Now, we hope you don't wreck your car, but if you do, come and see us. Our collision repair center is unique. There isn't one like it in the Intermountain West.
This is what my car looked like after that wreck. My life was turned upside down. Medical bills, car repairs, time off from work, and the insurance company wasn't being fair. They wouldn't even return my phone calls. So I called Keith Barton.
How much is fair? I'm attorney Keith Barton. If you've been hurt in a car wreck, call me now, and I'll get you the money you deserve.
I only wanted what was fair, and Keith Barton got it for me. Just one call, and he took care of everything. He got me $500,000.
It's a great time to buy a house right now. Interest rates are at an all-time low. You're not going to buy a house if you don't have a loan. It's the most important part of the puzzle. This is an average loan. This is what it takes to close a loan and process a loan. It's got to make you angry. How do you understand this? It's important that you do. And when you do a loan with me, I'm going to make sure you understand all of the information you're signing.
It's about all of us. News for Utah.
Took a while for the Utes to get their biggest lead, 8 points, but they enjoyed that at the break here at Salt Lake City, where Rick Majerus has won 173 games and lost only 16 as the Utah coach. Bob Carpenter, Jimmy Dykes back at halftime. Big rebounding edge for the Longhorns, but three-point shooting is doing it for Utah.
Utah has done it, and they've spread out the wealth. Five guys have made a three-point shot for Utah in the first 20 minutes of play. They've done it from all areas on their offense, Bob. They've done it, boom, out of their half-court set. You see one of the Johnson brothers jump up and stroke it. They've done it out of transition when Spivey found Jacobson running the right side of the floor. They've done it out of desperation at times, but this is a Utah club that makes 8 or 9 a game, and you have to take that away from them. And look at the rebounding advantage is what kept Texas in this ballgame. 11 offensive boards for Texas in the first 20 minutes. They have a 21-12 advantage overall in that department. And the bigger story may be Burgess and Owens both out of this game with injuries.
There's Chris Owens. They'll go back to Texas tomorrow. He's on crutches. They'll know more about his right knee. And Chris Burgess, a right foot injury, iced. He'll miss at least several more games, say the Utes. I hate to see things like that happen anytime. And in this case, just before conference play commences, when the games mean so much. In Texas's favor, they do have an easier conference schedule in the Big 12 in the month of January before they do in the month of February, when they really go on some death marches on the road in that league.
Yeah, but they are set up to get quickly out of the starting blocks in that Big 12 race. Keep an eye on Kansas now in the national picture. They've got speed this year in their lineup with Aaron Miles at that point guard spot they haven't had in the past.
Boddicker rejected by Britton Johnson. Where was Brian Boddicker in the first half? 10 minutes, no points, one rebound, one assist.
Where's he been all season? Again, he's one of the three high school All-Americans to ever don the burnt orange uniform of the Texas basketball player. He has got to become a factor for Rick Barnes.
Boddicker can't knock it down. Yeah, only three McDonald's All-Americans over the years. Chris Clack in 95, Boddicker in 2000, T.J. Ford the third. And now a 40-32 Utah lead. Utes with the ball, a chance to move it out to double figures here early out of halftime.
Boddicker not in that starting lineup right now because he's not consistently playing post defense and he's not rebounding. He's letting it affect his offense.
Johnson for Jacobson. That's Lance Allred posting up, going to the rack. Short with the banker. Johnson rejected by Klotz. And then Jeff Johnson, the last to touch it. Texas gets it back.
Rick Majerus applauds that first possession. They got the ball in the high percentage spot on the floor. Allred just couldn't finish. But he caught it and took it straight to the rim.
Allred stepping down to stop T.J. Ford. Boddicker misfires the three. Spivey the rebound. A guard at 6'1", who pulls down four rebounds a game.
Both point guards are great rebounders on the defensive end. Ford leads his club coming into this ball game with 50 defensive boards.
Jeff Johnson, along with that three, Boddicker, the Texas rebound. T.J. Ford, one assist in 17 minutes of the first half with two turnovers. Can't score there, and we've got a foul on Texas.
We see Ford push that ball all the way to the rim and got the defense out of alignment. You have to cover that guy, Bob, for 40 minutes because he's always on attack. He has great vision. He plays the game in different speeds, and so far Utah has graded out about an A-minus defending him as a unit. You don't defend him with one guy. You defend him with five.
Jason Klotz, his third foul a moment ago for the Horns. Johnson looking at Allred, Klotz leaning on him. A quick release from the baseline. It won't go for Jacobson. Outlet T.J. Ford. Longhorn shot 35% in the first half. Utah an even 50. And they were 1 of 10 from three-point range. Oops. Brandon Mouton a little behind the back pass in desperation, but it squirted right out over the sideline. Back in quickly, James Thomas to replace Jason Klotz. Rick Barnes is not one player short. He's about a player and a half short right now with Chris Owens hurt.
Bob, and Texas only shot 34% from the field in the first half. They only shot 41% as a team all of last year. It's not a club that is going to beat you just by jumping up and knocking down shots on you.
Britton Johnson went baseline, and Boddicker with a good defensive stop stayed right with him. Freddie Williams now for the Longhorns, and Brandon Mouton will get a seat.
Rick Majerus, what, fifth, I guess, coming into this game amongst active coaches as far as winning percentage. Only Tarkanian, John Kress, Roy Williams, and Boeheim have a better winning percentage than this guy.
Oh, yeah, great pass. T.J. Ford to James Thomas. Eight for Thomas, T.J.'s second assist of the day. 2.5 minutes out of halftime, the Horns are back to within six.
What great position by Thomas on that low block. You see how wide and low target he became.
Spivey lost Ford. T.J. slipped. Allred couldn't finish, but the guard's got to make that layup. Still can't. Thomas, the Texas rebound. A big defensive stop for the Longhorns. Backdoor cut, and Jeff Johnson figured it out. Here comes his little brother, Britton. 4-on-2. Left side, Allred. Stripped away by T.J. Ford, who nearly kept it in play for Texas.
How about the pass by Ford earlier? A couple of possessions to go by Texas. You see him just kind of set you up with that bouncy-type dribble, then boom. Thomas just steps in, and they burn you. And then you see Ford come into play. He's 5'10", blocking the shot of someone 6'11". Shouldn't happen.
Jacobson got it, squares up, knocks it down, that's a two. Nick Jacobson with 11 on the day.
Boy, he's got a pure stroke, doesn't he?
Mountain West freshman of the year last year when he averaged 8 points a game. First Ute with that honor since a young man named Keith Van Horn in 84. Off the hands of Boddicker, was it tipped away by Utah. Officials gonna get together, Steve Wilmer and Scott Thornley. And Scott says, I had a good look at it, Steve. It's going back the other way. Good officiating crews will pick each other up just like teammates.
Just like announcers.
and the load is often quite heavy. Phil Cullen back in for Utah. He'll replace Britton Johnson.
Get a good night's sleep before working with me, huh? See, Boddicker trying to make a move that basketball, and a little bit of contact initially, but I think it did fly off of his fingers. He was the last one to touch it. Texas struggling in the half-court offensive set right now without Owens on the floor.
Calling for Jeff Johnson. Working off a weave is Jacobson. Illegal moving pick, Eric Osmundson. His third foul of the game. He's played about 3 minutes, and he's got three fouls.
Sometimes an illegal moving screen occurs because the guy getting screened for moves too early. Not sure if that was the case. However, I'll say this. If you don't get called for at least one moving screen a game, you're probably not screening enough.
Rennie Williams penetrating. Finger roll short. Rebound finds Jacobson. Taken away from behind. Great hustle play by Dejanil Erskine, but the Horns couldn't keep it. Straight ahead, Allred, the turnaround, rolls it home. Lance Allred, a field goal in each half, spelling the injured Chris Burgess.
Allred plays hard. He had good minutes at Alabama in their loss.
Williams right at the big fellas, and he takes a body from Lance Allred. Lance with his third. Guy on the Utah club who suffers from a hearing disability. His teammates just love him, and he's working hard today.
There's that last illegal screen call by Utah, and the shooter, this time it was John Jacobson coming off before the screener was coming down to set the screen. You've got to wait. You got to, if anything, you're late when you're being screened for, not early, and that time Jacobson was early.
Freddie Williams, 5 points today, all at the line. Allred gets a breather. Cameron Colford back for Utah. Lance with three. Freddie Williams had an MCL sprain and a partially torn ACL. It held him out until today. Got a big brace on that left knee. And he's got six of them today from the line. 8 point game like it was at halftime. 4:04 into the second half.
Cuff me, call me Shirley.
Save big bucks on every call. Just dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
In 1935, Foxwood Farm started with one horse and a truck. The horse was a thoroughbred, the truck a Chevy Suburban. Today, they have a few more horses. But there's still only one truck, Chevy Suburban. With an available 8.1-liter Vortec engine, it's capable of towing up to 6 tons, making it the best Suburban yet. Chevy Suburban, like a rock.
NCAA basketball presented by UBS Payne Weber on ABC Sports. Brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
NCAA basketball presented by UBS Payne Weber. Bob Carpenter, Jimmy Dykes at the Hunstman Center, Salt Lake City. They're getting ready for the Olympics here. They will actually take their semester break here between February 1st and the 26th so the students can clear out for the Olympic Village and all the other things going on.
Big story of this game, Jimmy Dykes, T.J. Ford, and the matchup against the coach, Rick Majerus.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen Rick Majerus before come in with a game plan designed to take away the other team's strength. T.J. Ford is the strength of Texas when he leads the country in assists right now with 10 a game. He has two in this ball game because of the great health principles that Utah's throwing at him right now.
Cameron Colfer couldn't quite knock that one down. Here's Ford, straight ahead. Royale Ivy. He's been rather quiet today, really. Ivy not as much impact in this game as we normally see him have. Reginald Erskine up there to set a high pick, but look at the Utes double out on the point guard.
When that happens, the guy setting the screen has to be a threat.
Ivy blocked. Johnson on the floor with Williams. And a held ball. Possession arrow belongs to Utah. Trace King coming back in for the Utes. And Terrell Ross, who played a couple of minutes in the first half, back in for the Longhorns.
Ross is another perimeter defender at 6'3", 6'4", that can lock you up out there. Fits right into Rick Barnes' system on that end of the floor.
Yep, very athletic, and they've had that around Austin a long time. Caton, Osmondson, and some of that tough defense. As the Longhorns extend, they use Terrell Ross, and they get the turnover. Second half shooting a little quiet. First half, 50% for the Utes, and down under 20 since.
A little bit of a different look for T.J. Ford this afternoon than he's seen all season. This is a Utah club that defends as a group as well as anyone he'll face his entire college career. The help defense is rotating on him right now. He's big and tall. He's not used to that.
Good ball movement by the Longhorns. James Thomas into double figures with that basket. And we've got a six-point game. Close as the Longhorns have been since the halftime when they trailed by eight.
Thomas taking the load of the scoring punch that Owens has sitting on the sidelines right now.
You find out things about your club in this situation, don't you? There's a reach in by Freddie Williams, his third foul. Next Saturday, a chance to represent the U.S. right here in Salt Lake City on the line as America's top men compete in the Giant Slalom and the Moguls. The U.S. Ski Team Gold Cup presented by Chevy Trucks. Coverage begins next Saturday at 1 Eastern, 3 Pacific on ABC. Slopes just to the east of us here. We'll see a lot of Olympic thrills in the month of February.
They're almost concerned about having too much snow for the Olympics this year.
Yeah, they've had to shoot off a few guns and cause some avalanches up there.
Who would have ever thought that? Too much snow for the Winter Olympics. Makes no sense to a guy from Arkansas.
Little does.
Think about it.
Loose ball for T.J. Ford. You can have too much snow. It's just like putting too much lacquer on a basketball floor. Some folks say Utah doesn't put any on here. That's why guys are slipping sometimes. Terrell Ross over to T.J. Ford. Driving, unable to finish. Jeff Johnson the rebound. Boddicker stayed with it. He knocked it out of bounds, and Utah has the ball.
One of the areas where Ford will continue to improve throughout his career is on that move right there. He can get to the rim right now anytime he wants. He can't always finish. Just a little bit of a bump or contact on him throws him off right now, but he'll get to where he can finish that play as he gets older.
Travis Spivey walks the ball up the floor. Travis and his mate T.J. Ford matching up today. T.J., by the way, 3-for-12 with that last miss. Caton for Allred. Shot clock approaching 10. First time we've mentioned that apparatus in this half. Game clock running down toward 13 minutes. Shot clock at 4. Britton Johnson got iron. Trace Caton a rebound. Underneath, can't get a shot. They get a fresh 35 seconds, though.
Caton's one of those guys that'll get you an extra 2 or 3 possessions a game because of that type of play. Only 6'4 and a half, but he had the biggest heart.
Spivey again can't finish at the end. Freddie Williams for Texas. Right down the middle. And that is a blocking foul against Utah's Eric Osmondson. Three Utes were waiting for Freddie Williams.
Osmondson maybe got a little deep. You see, he's going to make his stand right there with the Mountain West sticker. And he had help defenders on both sides. Step up, get your feet set, and take him on. I mean, Williams is quick. Knee brace and all, he still has the ability to make you miss him.
Back in for Texas, number 3, Brandon Luton, replacing number 10.
Ouch.
That's both clubs, not two players, folks. At the half, it was 40-32 Utah. It's become a grinder here in Salt Lake City.
Bob, I will say this. The defense that both clubs are throwing on you right now have something to do with that shooting percentage. You and I have seen Utah a lot over the last 3 years. They defend you as well as anybody in this part of the country. And Rick Barnes' squad, they defend you as well as anybody in that part of the country.
Here's Mouton, little pull-up jumper. Short, Britton Johnson got it away from Boddicker. Releases for Spivey. Half-court motion, four out, one in by Utah. Cullen, that's what happens. You got to step out and respect his three, and then he can blow by you. Jason Klotz, playing with three fouls, saw the big fella just go right past him.
Well, with Cullen and Britton Johnson on the floor right now playing the four and five spot, that's what you're going to get right there is the ability for both of those guys to catch it on the perimeter and go by somebody. Most four and five people defensively can't match up with that move right there that Cullen just threw at him.
Phil Cullen, 8 points off the bench. His best game of the year so far, nine in 12 minutes against Pepperdine. He had eight with five rebounds in 14 minutes against Southern Utah.
Rick Barnes forced to go to a smaller lineup right now to match up with Utah's two bigs and three smalls as well.
Cullen with nine. Utes by eight, 12 and a half to go. Couple of clubs with records of 7-3. Utah's won four straight. Texas, six in a row. Terrell Ross, tough shot. Cullen, the Utah rebound.
Well, good job, Cullen, to get that rebound and then made room to make the pass. See that big step out to the side? That was for a purpose. It freed him up to make the outlet pass.
He sets a high pick on Boddicker. Johnson, left side, Trace Cape. Mouton defending. A look in. Jacobson, jump hook, short. Britton Johnson had it, lost it. There were three Longhorns in there, and Terrell Ross came up with it. Here's T.J. Ford. Inside that arc, he's been deadly, but he can't rattle that one in.
Ford, the most popular guy in this Longhorn club because of his ability and want to in this as far as passing the basketball.
Good pass there to Dejanald Erskine, who flashes down the lane, draws a Utah foul.
Really unusual for a freshman to step in at this level and bring the confidence that T.J. Ford brings to the floor and to his teammates. They feel like they can score on anybody when that guy's in the game.
Eight and a half out of halftime. Utes by eight.
Many internet services use lots of words to sell you, but conveniently forget to tell you how much they cost. Just for the record, most cost over $20 a month. Meanwhile, Net Zero and Juno are only $9.95, less than half the price. Maybe the others prefer words because the numbers speak for themselves. Join the millions who have united online. Call 877-ONLY-995 or visit us at netzero.net or juno.com. Additional phone charges may apply.
Hey, Edge Gel is gonna clean up your act with Edge Clean Shave Gel.
Edge Clean.
Edge Clean's got a built-in facial cleanser that helps lift dirt and oil every time you lather. To help lift dirt and oil every time you shave.
Edge Clean Complete.
So clean up your act with Edge Clean Shave Gel.
Agent Bristow is quite simple.
American woman, American woman, listen to what I say.
There's been a hit put out on Cindy. I'm getting her out of there.
Taking them down is what gets her up in the morning.
You're no good. Who are you?
I'm no good for you.
Alias, Sundays at 9, 8 central on ABC.
Well, but your local, everybody.
NCAA basketball presented by UBS Payne Weber. We're in Salt Lake City, home of the Utes. They lead the Texas Longhorns of the Big 12, 46-38. A big Texas day at the offensive rebounding end, except in this half, where suddenly Utah has gone crashing with Chris Owens out of this game.
Well, the adjustment that Rick Majerus made at the halftime, I'm sure he spent probably 15 of the 20-minute session talking about keep Texas off the offensive glass, and you see they listen well.
Hard guy to ignore. Unbelievable meticulous preparation for each and every game. Rick Majerus. Mouton, that's an air ball, might have been tipped. Erskine, Trace Caton stripped him. Britton Johnson fouled by T.J. Ford. Utes, they call them the running Utes, and they were off to the other end right there.
The rip and run with the best of them. I mean, once they secure that ball, then boom, they flood that floor, and they flood the middle of the floor a lot of times with their big guys and just leak out and get an easy two or three a game on you if you don't run with them. Tell you what, there's no wasted dribbling out of Utah in their half-court set. The ball never touched the floor on that possession.
Britton Johnson missing the three. Mouton the Texas rebound. T.J. Ford transitions. Ford with penetration. Tough shot. He knocks it down. T.J. Ford with 9 points today.
Well, he's really good at shooting that ball from about 8 or 10 feet off the dribble. He has tough shot ability, tough shot mentality built into him.
He's had some good scoring games, 16 against Indiana in Alaska, 17 against Jacksonville, 15 with 8 assists at UNLV last Saturday.
Well, his high school team, Willow Ridge High School out of Houston, 72-1 the last 2 years. And there's the versatility of Utah's offense, Bob, to step their big guy out on the floor and knock down threes. Not a lot of clubs have that.
Phil Cullen's second three of the day, his 11th of the year.
There you see Ford. That's tough shot mentality and ability right there out of Ford. Then boom, that's inverting your offense. Let your guards go in down the side and let your big guy step out and answer for you with a three-point shot.
That's Phil Cullen's 116th three, number 5 all-time on the Utah list. I don't think he'll catch the 206 that Keith Van Horn knocked down. And there's another one. Nick Jacobson, timeout, Texas. Biggest lead, Utah.
And that one's off the out-of-bounds play. We talked about it earlier. Two or three times a game, they'll burn you from the out-of-bounds spot, and Jacobson did it.
It's going to be raining snow later. It's raining threes right now in Salt Lake City.
This is Silverado Heavy Duty. Available with the Duramax diesel. The most powerful diesel you can get in a pickup. Silverado Heavy Duty. More truck from Chevy.
How do you envision Utah's future?
I envision a region-wide transportation system taking me from home to work, shopping, and recreation.
Communities with housing choices to meet the needs of Utahns through all stages of life. That's my vision.
I see a future where our quality of life attracts top employers and great jobs.
Share your vision for the future with your local officials. You and Envision Utah. It's a difference we can make together.
Will he deal?
You bet we will. Right now, everyone wants you to check out their year-end specials. Only at Willie Ford and Willie Honda will you get the best price up front. In fact, if you don't get an exact quote of what your new vehicle will cost in the first 5 minutes you arrive, you're simply at the wrong dealership. Yes, you'd be crazy not to shop and compare. Check the others out. We know you'll be glad you visited us. Remember the year's very best prices on our entire inventory of new and used Fords and Hondas right up front. No games. That's the Willie deal.
Utah Winter Games, only on 4Utah.
Two quick threes by Utah, and a dozen is the lead.
Bob, watch this little wheel version of their out-of-bounds play for Nick Jacobson. He's number 15 right at the top of your screen right now in the middle of the floor. Now, his first setup is a setup move. Boom, hold it right there. He takes about two steps towards the baseline to get his defensive man buried amongst all that traffic. Now they start the wheel motion. His defender's buried inside. He gets picked off by a double screen. Jacobson catch, release, rotation, result. Again, a club, Utah, that really takes advantage of that ball on the out-of-bounds line. It was a great setup move by Jacobson to free himself up.
Look at that, 63% of their points off the three. Today, they have a 24-point advantage on Texas in three-point shooting. 9 makes to 1 by the visitors. Overall, Utah, 9 of 16 beyond the arc.
Utah has shot it well from the perimeter, and they've negated the ability of Ford to get inside and make plays.
Back iron miss. Here come the Utes. Freddie Williams set the check back in for Texas. Straight ahead and unable to corral that one. Britton Johnson. There's a deflection by Spivey. Ford, the trailer. He started, he finished, and DJ Ford has 11 points.
Clever little move by Ford. Anytime he lowers his shoulder, Bob, which he did that time, that tells you he's going to the rim. That's his trademark move. Dip that shoulder, boom, blow by somebody.
Down goes Cullen. Boddicker a foul. That'll be his second. Brian Boddicker has not scored today. 16 fouls. DJ Ford gets a breather. Freddie Williams back.
Bob, watch the shoulder right here. Watch him lower it. When he lowers it, boom. See that little duck right there? That tells you I'm going to the rim and try to finish on you. All great guards. You go look back to Andre Miller when he played here. When they make their move to go, they dip that shoulder and get lower and get by someone.
Nick Jacobson runs the point for Utah. High pick and roll Cullen. Now he goes and sets one. Trace Caton, the left wing. Utes are never stationary. Quick catch and a shot, and it's too strong for Jacobson. Now he'll shoot a three. That might have been a heartbreaker had that one gone down, coming off the offensive rebound. Here's Williams for Texas. See the Freddie looking pretty good with that knee, by the way.
Yeah, did you see the three white jerseys there, though, to meet the initial drive of the basketball by Texas? That's that built-in help that Utah's thrown at them all afternoon.
Williams thinking about the three. Spivey in front of him. Ross for Mouton. Pull-up jumper, baseline right. He drills it. Brandon Mouton averaging 13, only his second field goal of the day. And with 8:40 to go, the Horns are back to within 8. Jeff Johnson at the table to check in for Utah.
Utah club, though, Bob, that you won't get them out of character, out of their personality. You're going to keep turning that thing over, getting a good ball reversal within each possession. Real premium on high percentage shots. There's another one by Jacobson.
Rims out on him. Oh, and the offensive rebound. Britton Johnson, only his third field goal of the day. But a big one there. They're back up by 10.
Tough to box out a guy that's 6'11 and 205. You can't get a body on him because you can't find him.
And he's pretty quick, too. Got good feet. Mouton for three. Almost banked it. Jacobson a touch. Loose ball, Johnson. Spivey walks it up. 7:50 to go.
See Rick McGarris up with both palms pointed down at the floor. Meaning slow this thing down, make Texas work on defense. Again, they've spent a lot of time, the guys in orange, on defense in this ball game.
Spivey, a good look for Cullen. Bad angle, though. That'll be his third.
Utah, number 15, Nick Jacobson. Two fouls on Jacobson.
Klotz back for Texas. Royale Ivy back. He's only scored 4 points today. Texas, a club that's averaging 80 points a game. But it's been forever since Majerus has given up 80. And a big play there for Britton Johnson. Utes by 10.
From Tech Expo, this is Sarah Brunel.
And clear.
So this mobile internet, what companies are making that happen?
So Sarah, listen, I emailed you our analyst reports on those companies, but I gotta tell you, based on your long-term goals, you're already overweighted in stocks.
Thank you.
Mom's here.
Dad?
Yeah?
I got an acceptance letter.
Great, where?
Boston.
Boston? Wow, that is great. Boston. Boston.
I guess I just didn't figure on the school being 3,000 miles away.
You know, those zero coupon bonds we got you into will more than cover costs. It's not going to be easy having her so far away, is it?
Hey, Jim. Where are you now? You're breaking up.
I'm a mama's boy. I pity the fool who ain't one. Mama misses you. So when you call her collect, dial 1-800-COLLECT. It'll save her a buck or two. Mama loves saving with 1-800-COLLECT. 1-800-COLLECT, save a buck or two.
You think you have it rough? Ever try fighting a dozen lurkers at once? Those guys make purse snatchers seem like Boy Scouts. You fight any 300-foot robots today? Didn't think so.
It looks like your partner's doing all the work.
Maybe it looks that way to the untrained eye. Huh? Hey, big guy! Been there long?
A new legacy is born. Rated E for everyone.
I'm a mama's boy. I pity the fool who ain't one. Mama misses you. So when you call her collect, dial 1-800-COLLECT. It'll save her a buck or two. Mama loves saving with 1-800-COLLECT. 1-800-COLLECT, save a buck or two.
NCAA basketball presented by UBS Payne Weber on ABC Sports. Brought to you by UBS Payne Weber, because life is a continuing story.
Well, some high-flying threes here at the Hunstman Center today. The rebounding story is interesting. It's now only a two-rebound advantage after Texas had dominated earlier. And the genius of Majerus seems to resurface once more. Today, an offense that's averaging 80 points a game, Texas, just over halfway there. And there's 7:30 to go, 46 in a row. Majerus's defense not allowing 80. The last time it happened, February 28th of the year 2000, when they lost, giving up 88 at Wyoming.
You and I were there, and Laramie, Wyoming was rocking that night, and Steve McClain's club were beating anyone in the country the way they shot the ball that evening.
88-61 was that score. Britton Johnson on the foul.
Bob, you like clubs that make adjustments at halftime, make adjustments during timeouts, and I can't overemphasize the importance of Utah's ability to take Texas out of the game on the offensive glass in the second half. They had 11 the first 20 minutes and only one so far the second half.
Bad mistake right in front of the coach. NHL hockey, three great matchups. You'll see either of these next Saturday. Avalanche Red Wings, the Rangers, the Penguins, or the Capitals and the Bruins. It all starts next Saturday live at 3 Eastern, noon Pacific, the NHL on ABC. Johnson down to Allred. It's stopped there by Jason Klotz. Utes got it back. Shot clock still running. It's under 15. 7 minutes to go. Utah by 10. Back cut, Johnson trying to do a little 180, and a ball going over the baseline.
He really had no other choice, otherwise he was going to charge, so he slipped the thing behind his back. Trying to find Allred down low, and I'm impressed with how Utah has continued to click without their main stud on the inside, Chris Burgess, today.
Burgess left after 5 minutes with a bad foot injury. Crossy turnaround, nicely done. Jason Klotz, 5 points on the day. Getting a little better every time out. Redshirt freshman.
This Texas team is young, aren't they? Only a couple of seniors, and got guys like Klotz and Ford that are freshmen, logging a lot of valuable minutes. Freshman, sophomore, junior dominated club from Rick Barnes.
Allred down deep again. Kicks at Trace Caton. They can't hit a three now, Utah. They've missed about five in a row. Spivey got it back, and Johnson. Long rebounding for three-point shots. Tough to gauge sometime if you're the defense. Allred unable to finish. Mouton the rebound. Freddie Williams looking to penetrate. Shoveling for Ivy. Pull-up jumper, drilling it, and here come the horns. Timeout Majerus. Six-point game. Just under 6 minutes to go. And a bit of an altercation on the floor. Texas coaches a good job of getting out there and pushing their kids over toward the bench.
Well, Freddie Williams and one of the Utah players got into a little locked arms, push and shove match. Great penetration by Freddie Williams to get that last bucket for Texas.
Steve!
Maybe a little John after the play is what got the thing ignited, though.
So Majerus has to call his second timeout. Long way to go in this one, 5:58. And the Horns back to within six. An 8-2 Texas run over the last 2:51.
See if we can see what happens at the end of the play. Freddie Williams on the left corner of your screen for Utah in the orange jersey. Now watch him step into the picture. And right there is when it gets a little chest to chest, a little bumping going on with Spivey. And then they kind of just go at each other a little bit. Everybody's talking during the holiday season. You don't need that. Play the game with passion, play it with fire, but act like you've been here before.
Well, the Longhorns have been on the road before. They went to the Great Alaska Shootout, beat Oregon State by 10, lost to Gonzaga by 3, Indiana by 6. A great win in overtime over Stanford in Chicago by 8. Went to Vegas and won by 9 a week ago. When Rick Barnes's Longhorns start Big 12 play, they will be road-tested tough.
I like what he's done with his club this year, Bobby. He's opened them up a little bit on the offensive end. They've become a running team. Now, Utah has taken that away from them today, but that's their style for the rest of this season. Not a quick shot team, a running team. There's a big difference.
Great look. Big brother to little brother, Jeff DeBritton Johnson. 9 for Britt, and a big basket for Utah. Mouton for 3, no. Klotz goes up, stripped of the ball, gets it again. Play continues, finally a whistle.
Utah.
It'll be a foul on Utah's Trace Caton, his third.
Bob, Utah, a club that really takes advantage of their timeouts, and this time in their last timeout, this is the set play that they call. Knowing we need a high percentage shot, Texas has cut into our lead. Let's run a special set. We've been running our motion most of the afternoon. Come out of that timeout with a special play. Boom, get an easy 2 points because of it.
At the line, Jason Klotz. Not a bad free throw shooter, 9 out of 12 so far this year.
Well, I like his size and I like his commitment to defend that low post, to rebound and run the floor all the time. That's what has him in the starting lineup right now. Boddicker's a better offensive player. Klotz more consistent in all areas.
Medical redshirt because of an ankle last year. Horns came in at 66%. Perfect from the strike today. Until then, look at the rebound, Thomas. He got all tied up, and Klotz shields off about 3 guys so Freddie Williams can pick up that ball. And if Texas scores here, they're down by 5, maybe 4.
Second offensive rebound of the second half out of Texas. Thomas just went and snatched it, didn't he?
Boy, Cullen having quite a battle with him down there. Klotz goes down, doesn't travel. Shot clock at 13. Game clock 5:05. Williams on the wing. Ivy pulls back. His sneakers were on the line. The 2 is short. Mouton goes up. Yes! And a foul. Big play. Brandon Mouton.
Should be a good offensive rebounder at 6'4 from that wing position, Brandon Mouton. That time he crashes that weak side and boom, he just comes up with it. Nobody got a body on him and he just ran to the weak side of the rim and got it and then had the strength to take it through contact as a chance for a 3-point play.
To make it a 4-point game. Utah led by 12. 8 of that has evaporated. Brandon Mouton with 7. Rick Majerus concerned. Rick Barnes, meanwhile, brings in Dejanil Erskine from the bench. One of his strong rebounders, a guy who can hit the boards. Even at the offensive end, 4:50 to go. Crucial time now for Utah, having seen two-thirds of their lead disappear.
Texas now coming with their pressure again, and it gets a turnover because of it. They rushed the passer who was calling, got him a turnover.
Rick Majerus sees some warning signs here and wants a 30-second timeout. This has been an interesting series. They've gone home and home. They've met 8 times. Each team has a 3-1 advantage on their home court. And the last time they met, Jimmy Dykes, a senior by the name of Darren Kelly would have a big game for the Longhorns of Texas.
Well, he scored in bunches of ways, and then Texas blocked 11 shots in that ball game. This is the club that plays awfully well above the rim last year and this year. And Texas, I'm telling you what, they won a ton of games last year, shooting 41% as a team. Common denominator of all four teams that reached the Final Four last year, they all shot 48% or better from the field. Rick Barnes' club won 25 games last year, shooting 41%.
They went 25-9, 12-4 in the Big 12. Went to the championship game of the tournament when Oklahoma beat them. After they had knocked off Oklahoma State and Baylor, lost to Temple, first round of the NCAA at New Orleans. But Rick Barnes has been there three consecutive times with this club, and we think he's going back again. Last time Texas led, long time ago, 12:27 to go first half. On the pass, a Utah foul, and the fouls are mounting on Britton Johnson. He's got four of them now, and here at the Hunstman Center, hometown crowd of the Utes, a little bit quiet right now. This building, the roundhouse that holds 15,000, watching the home team lose their 12-point lead. A couple of free throws here, gets it down to two.
Bob, I really like how active Thomas is on the interior, not only as an offensive rebounder, but just on that last play. He saw that his man defensively was cheating up the floor a little too high, so he just reads it, takes a hard back cut to the rim, and gets himself to the free throw stripe. I mean, he's really a handful. If Owens gets back healthy, he and Thomas are a headache for those Big 12 teams this winter.
6'8", 220, sophomore. Sophomores on this club scoring 52% of the Texas points, 47% of their rebounds, 49% of their minutes. They are young and they are good. Chris Owens went out about 10 minutes into the game with a right knee injury. They don't know how he is just yet. Spivey improvising well after his defender fell down. Travis with only his second field goal today. Utah by four.
Good job by Spivey to pull up and shoot the little 6 or 7 footer instead of over-penetrating and taking a chance of getting a shot blocked.
Eddie Williams out along the arc. Spivey comes out to close on him. Luton will probe the right side. Tough shot. Right there to follow it in. Is that Erskine? First basket of the day. We told you he's good on the offensive glass. Was a walk-on. He's now on a one-year scholarship. He's one of those year-to-year guys. And the Utes are only ahead by two. Thomas breaks up that alley-oop. Backdoor attempt for Britton Johnson. We've got a game in Salt Lake. 3:25 to go. Utah leads by two. Who's going to make the big plays down the stretch in this one?
After the new Chevy Trailblazer, everything else just seems kind of weak. The all-new 270 horsepower Chevy Trailblazer, like a rock.
One, two, three, four.
Going along, feeling fine when it hits you. Diarrhea. Alone, it's bad. But with gas and cramps too, you've got big trouble. But now there's new Imodium Advanced Caplets, the only one that combines two medicines to stop diarrhea, cramps, and gas all at once. In no time, you'll feel A-OK again. New Imodium Advanced Caplets. Whew, what a relief.
The thrill of victory. Go! And the agony of defeat.
Down goes Frazier!
Celebrate 40 years of ABC's Wide World of Sports tonight.
If ever there were a year the world needed to come together, this is the year, and this is the place.
On New Year's Eve, we're reaching out to the world again.
ABC 2002, Monday, starting at 6:30, 5:30 Central. Then the countdown continues.
With New Year's, New Year's.
Live from Times Square, it's Dick Clark with today's hottest music.
What are you doing, New
Year? Catch Dick Clark's New Year's Rockin' Eve right after ABC 2002.
Well, over the last couple of years, Texas, a very athletic club, Jimmy. Some of that athletic ability starting to come to the forefront here as they make the big comeback.
Well, they're getting some offensive rebounds the last 3 or 4 minutes, and that's what Rick Majerus was so concerned with, Texas' ability to make plays above the rim. They did it in the first half. They've done it in the last 3 minutes of this ball game.
Stepped up their defense. Here's a guy who can do it at both ends. UBS Payne Weber, Senior of the Week, Oklahoma State's Mo Baker. On the court, he's averaging 18.7 rebounds. Off the court, he helps feeding the homeless, mentoring underprivileged kids in the central Oklahoma area. UBS Payne Weber will donate $1,000 to its Senior of the Week Scholarship Fund in the name of Cowboy senior Maurice Baker.
Well, he led the charge last Saturday when they were down 32-10 at Arkansas. He and Victor Williams, two experienced guards for Eddie Sutton, they will be a handful in the Big 12.
Big basket. Talk about experience. Jeff Johnson of Utah got a push from Brandon Mouton, was able to finish the play.
Bob again out of a timeout. Utah draws up a play to isolate Johnson on the weak side of the floor. Reverse the ball to him. Lower your shoulder and go to the rim. They got him the ball and he knows one thing. I'm going to the rim and get the thing up and at worst get myself to the free throw stripe.
Can't knock down the three-point play. Utah by four. 3:10 to go. Texas playing with a great sense of urgency right now. Ivy. Out top with Mouton. Williams, tough entry. Thomas, stopped by Cullen. Looked like James Thomas was going to go ahead and finish that play.
Well, Texas making their run right now with T.J. Ford on the bench. He only has one foul. Freddie Williams has actually done a better job of penetrating with that basketball than Ford has in this game.
Spivey for Jacobson. Yeah, got the roll. That's a two. Nick Jacobson having a big day. 16 for him. And the crowd's into it now at the Hunstman Center. 6-point Utah lead, 2.5 to go. Mouton crosses the baseline. Kicks it Erskine. Down to Thomas, who knocked it out. Utah's going to get it back.
Utah with great ball movement during clutch time. You see them keep that floor spread. There's not one white jersey within 15 feet of another white jersey. As a result, a shooter comes off of a screen, catch it, drop it down. Beautiful offense out of the Utes.
Yeah, the kind of spacing he used to get a three. Jacobson was right inside the arc. Here he goes baseline right. In trouble. I thought he came down. Yeah, he came down back on his foot before he was able to make that pass. Rick Barnes wants a 30-second timeout. A minute 57 to go.
Not the strength of Jacobson putting the ball on the floor into his shot. He's a terrific catch and shoot type kid. Great defensive play that time by Royal Ivy out on the perimeter, forcing the jump ball.
One of the best defensive players in the nation. A minute 57 to go in this one. 62-56, Utah leads Texas. Tonight, join Al Michaels, Dennis Miller, Dan Fouts, a special Monday night football holiday bash. Ray Lewis and the Ravens go to Tampa Bay. Keyshawn Johnson and the Buccaneers await. You will see some serious playoff intensity tonight. Ravens Bucks tonight at 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific on ABC.
While you're flying home, I'm going to watch that one. Baltimore wins, they're in. You love watching games that have a meaning. That one does tonight.
Well, we're told that San Diego State of the Mountain West hanging with Duke, at least, down by 12. Couple of minutes to go on that one at Cameron Indoor Stadium. That's an improving club in this league out here. 62-56, Texas in a two-possession game.
Boy, look at that Mountain West right now. Utah, Wyoming, New Mexico, San Diego State. They're all mentioned in the same sentence in this part of the country. No clear favorite.
They're playing off, way off Freddie Williams. Three is short. Big rebound, James Thomas. Ivy blocked by Jeff Johnson. Collins got it. What a play by the senior.
Two great plays right there. The rebound by Thomas and the block shot by Johnson. Two plays made because they have big Valentines. I love watching guys play with that kind of passion.
Clock running down to a minute 10. Yep. Rather, Britton Johnson fouled on his drive. Good thing for him, he was well off balance, and James Thomas got him. Utes will go to the line, leading by six with a minute and nine to go. What a big win this could be. This could be the first real name win for Utah this year.
Yeah, a great block by Johnson. And look, to catch that ball before it goes out of bounds, he stays in bounds at the same time, finds another white jersey. That is a tremendous individual play by Jeff Johnson.
Looked like an NFL receiver checking his feet as he came down with the ball.
While this Utah club, they'll shoot a lot of free throws all season long, primarily because of Britton Johnson, Phil Cullen. Those guys are hard to match up with because they're 6'9 and can put the ball on the floor. A lot of reaching, grabbing, hacking fouls because of them.
The first free throw did make it a three-possession game. Utah by seven, running down to the final minute here in Salt Lake City. Royale Ivy twisting, turning, scoring. Timeout, Rick Barnes.
Maybe should have gotten a little bit more out of Royale Ivy earlier in this ball game because he's consistent. He's got size and strength to take the ball to the heart of the defense and make a play just like he did right there.
They've had two crazy games in this series over the years, and Tremaine Wingfield, maybe in that game in 93, the craziest of all. Watch this. 2/10 of a second to go 94 feet. End of regulation. We're going to OT. But that wasn't all. How about the second overtime? Tie score, making like Christian Laettner, the banker. And the horns shocked Utah in Austin.
You know, I think it was shortly after that that the NCAA put in the rule that 0.3 seconds or less, you can only tip a shot.
Right.
Because that shot by Wingfield occurred with 0.2 on the clock. In today's game, it would have not counted.
Yeah, that was 9 years ago, folks. So the officials had it right at that time. Chris Burgess on crutches. Chris Owens on crutches. 58.7 seconds to go. Utah by five. Texas goes man on the inbounds play.
They face guard. They use a center fielder trying to deny everybody. And Spivey gets away with it.
Fouled by Royale Ivy in the backcourt. For Royale, his fourth.
But when you're facing against a club that throws that full court facing you, total denial defense that Texas was throwing at you, you have to have a guy like Spivey that can get himself open. Spivey that time just made a little jab step and was like a heat-seeking missile coming for that basketball. Very important to have a guy that understands, get himself open in that situation.
If he hits them both, it's back to a three-possession game.
Spivey is the quiet leader of this team, Bob. He's tough. He's a competitor. They follow his lead a lot of times. He doesn't do a lot of scoring for you. If he just comes down to who wants to win the game the most, number 11 in the white jersey ranks right up there with the best of them.
He is deep in concentration. His coach crouched over in intensity, desperately wanting this free throw to get it back to a 7-point lead.
Talked to Rick Majerus about 2 weeks ago, and he said, all I'm concerned with is getting my team better every afternoon in practice. Utah historically, they don't start off quickly out of the gates, but they always finish strong.
T.J. Ford driving, leaving it off for Freddie Williams. Probing the perimeter. Britton Johnson out to guard him. Double team. Boddicker for three. They got to have it. They got it. Timeout, Texas. Timeout. 42.5 seconds to go here in Salt Lake City. And after a three-point basket by Boddicker, Texas timeout. We welcome those of you who've been watching Duke and San Diego State. We've got another Mountain West Conference team for you here in Salt Lake City. The running Utes of Utah, Bob Carpenter with Jimmy Dykes at the Hunstman Center. It was Utah by eight at the half using three-point shooting. Jimmy, Texas, a solid comeback in this half. They're down four now with 42.5. Brian Boddicker just hit a big three for them.
Freddie Williams has played a lot of minutes at that point guard spot, his first game back in a long time off a knee injury. T.J. Ford has been on the bench during the comeback. Texas, Bob, they've also gotten back in this ball game by getting some offensive rebounds in the last 4 or 5 minutes of this thing.
For those of you who haven't been with us the whole way, Chris Owens hurt his knee 10 minutes into the game. He has not played since. They'll check on it when the ball club gets back to Austin tomorrow. 5 minutes before that, Chris Burgess severely turned his ankle, injured his foot, and he too is on crutches, and he's going to miss the next several Utah games. Rick Barnes is out of timeouts. Rick Majerus of Utah has two left, each team in the double bonus. Possession arrow belongs to the Longhorns. They'll set up some full court man-to-man on the inbounds play here. Down by four, 42.5 to go.
Texas with their smallest lineup of the afternoon on the floor. Obviously his best five, quickest full court pressing team is out there again. Full court denial, and they run one long.
They go for the touchdown. Ivy, it's complete, he scores. Travis Spivey with nine. Back up by six goes Utah. Still a two possession game. TJ Ford can't hit the layup. Jeff Johnson, the Utah rebound, and the Utes get it across midcourt. Here's another one. Britton Johnson, exclamation point. 8-point Utah lead. Jeff Johnson, a steal. Coast to coast. Rebound Jacobson. And a steal on the inbounds. It's all Utah in the last minute.
If you ever wanted to finish a game with a spurt, you just saw one. That was a serious, serious spurt. SSS.
71-61, Utah over Texas. A dramatic final minute for Rick Majerus. Intense ball game today, and the Mountain West beats the Big 12.
But Utah really shot that ball well from the three-point line, and they rebound the ball well enough to win. Not well enough for Rick Majerus to say thumbs up, but well enough to win the ball game.
Texas will be better when Chris Owens comes back. Final score, 71-61, Utah. ABC Sports Online at ESPN.com. Now back to John Saunders, Digger Phelps. Guys, it's yours in the studio.
All right, Bob, thanks a lot. Of course, you look at the final score of this one. Without Chris Owens, that one probably changes the 10-point margin. Just the same, Utah has now won five in a row. Texas, that ends a five-game losing streak.
Yeah, right. And you got to credit Rick Majerus with his team defense. When Owens goes out, you've got to understand this guy can get a double-double with points in the paint. What Utah did was tighten up defensively, like T.J. Ford goes 3-for-10 the first half. He's been averaging 10 assists a game. So now they take out the perimeter game. Texas cannot make threes, and Utah just stays tough enough defensively to pull this thing off. Majerus always gets his teams to play great defense when it counts.
Meanwhile, if you watch the Duke game, of course, Duke wins at the end. San Diego State goes on a great run, an 11-0 run, to get it down to the low double digits in this one, almost pulling one out towards the end. But Duke, as you looked at their schedule, and Dick put it up there, there's another game that wasn't there, and because of the proximity to the Maryland game, it adds up.
I really think Duke's next challenge will come January 17th when Maryland goes plays at Durham. They've won there the last 2 years, so Duke's going to be all fired up. Steve Blake has had Jason Williams' number the last 2 years, so that's another challenge. But after that game on the 19th, which is a Saturday, Wake Forest comes plays at Durham. There's no pressure on Wake Forest, so with all the energy you put into knocking off Maryland, where you have enough juice left, recover on Friday, go over to game plan for Saturday to play against Wake Forest. I think this will be Duke's greatest challenge, the 17th and 19th, before any other challenge in the ACC.
And one of the reasons why they accept so many of those challenges, Mike Krzyzewski, you can bet. He's pointed that out on the schedule as well. Stick around, the UBS Payne Weber postgame report in just a moment. We'll get you up to date on everything that's happened this afternoon in college basketball.